nine-yarder, which would beat Michigan.
It's on its way, and it's good.
Neither will Hayden Fry or kicker Rob Houtland. Number one Iowa beat number two Michigan 12-10 that afternoon, and today they'll meet again. It's the Hawkeyes versus the Wolverines, and we're live from Ann Arbor, Michigan. Welcome to the continuing saga of Michigan versus Iowa. When the Big Ten was known as the Big Two and the Little Eight, you'd always wait for Michigan and Ohio State. But hold on now, because Iowa and Michigan comes right into the middle as one of the best rivalries in the Midwest. So the Wolverines, who a year ago went down to the Fiesta Bowl and defeated Nebraska, while Iowa, as the result of beating Michigan and Iowa City, jetted west to the Rose Bowl and lost on New Year's Day to UCLA. And both of these fine schools now have Rose Bowl aspirations all over again. And here this afternoon, they come together unbeaten and untied, just as they were a year ago when they were ranked one and two. Neither team ranked that high, but they hope to get there, and here come the Wolverines. That national championship. Here's a fellow who's got a couple. Era Parsigian. Era, I want to tell you, I fully expect to see ambulances bring this Iowa team. What kind of mind games are these coaches playing with each other?
Can you imagine Bo Schembechler and Hayden Fry represent 50 years of experience in coaching, and Hayden's trying to psych out Bo. You know, he told him at the beginning of the week, I got 43 injuries. I'm going to be embarrassed on national television. And Bo just laughs, scoffs at it. Said he knows he's going to be living on both sides of the ball. And I'll guarantee it, he knows that I was here to play.
Speaking about Bo Schembechler, you were here a week ago when they beat up on Michigan State. This is a different kind of offense for the Wolverines.
It really is. This is a fine offensive team, a versatile team, multiple formations. They can run the football through option, power, or finesse, but it's the best passing attack that I have seen Michigan have. They do things exceptionally well, and Bo says himself, we can move the ball on anybody.
Now, Hayden Fry and the Hawkeyes coming onto the field here. Likewise, they're 5-0 in era. When we watched them beat Michigan State with that interception by Ken Sims with time running out, I was impressed with the way Hayden had replaced such key players like his quarterback, Chuck Law, and his tailback, Ronnie Harmon.
Well, they had heavy graduation losses, no question, but I think the thing that Hayden said, he said, we don't rebuild out here anymore, we reload. And, of course, we have seen him play against Michigan State, and they did an outstanding job in spite of a lot of injuries. And the one thing that the Michigan coaches fear the most, Hayden always comes up with new wrinkles, gadgets. We're going to see him out here this afternoon.
Yeah, we should point out that amidst all the injuries, Hayden is without a key defensive fella, Aaron.
Frost at left tackle, I think a sensational football player. We have watched him for 2 years. Was left at home because of a knee injury. That will be a big loss. Tim Anderson will step in for him, and he's got big shoes to fill.
All right, so this should be a dandy here this afternoon. Michigan and Iowa, and it's coming up. CBS Sports presents college football live from Michigan Stadium. From Ann Arbor, Michigan, it's the Iowa Hawkeyes versus the Michigan Wolverines. Today's game is sponsored by the Heartbeat of America, today's Chevrolet. The U.S. Armed Forces, it's a great place to start. Team Xerox, people and products that help bring out the genius in you. And by Michelob Light, super premium taste and less filling beer. A glorious afternoon, and someone who is happy to be with us today, Pat O'Brien. Pat?
All right, Brent, thank you. Looking around Michigan Stadium this afternoon, we don't have to remind people with these capacity crowds we see week after week of just how big football is in Ann Arbor. But let's turn our attention now to the Iowa fans who have come here 8,000 strong. Now, Brent, Saturday is a very special day for Iowans, especially the farmers, who got more bad news this week as the price per bushel of corn went to its lowest in 15 years. But that won't change, but you can take your mind off it. And in that sense, they say that Hayden Fry has done more for Iowa farmers than almost anybody else. Farmers like Archie and Shirley Buline and Fletty and Floyd and Betty Hutz and Jerry and Gene Neuschild are sitting in this section. They say, Brent, that now at least 9 or 10 times a year, they have something to smile about. And that's not a bad idea to forget our troubles and go out and watch some football. Brent, let's go to work.
All right, Patrick, indeed we will. And there is the kickoff man, Mike Gillette, with the ball teed off for the Wolverines, and Iowa will have possession here first. That's Robert Smith with his back turned to you, the speedy wide receiver. And sometimes turn it into a big game. And speaking of Ronnie Harmon, there's his brother, Kevin Harmon, wearing number 28. He's one of the tailbacks for Hayden Fry this afternoon.
Stepped in for injured Dave Hudson, has done very well. And Rick Bayless, a surprise on the team, averaging 7 points per carry.
So Pahulski brings the Hawkeyes, and they open up with split backs on first down. Here run Bayless behind the left side, and then they turned it up to about the 23-yard line. And the nose guard, Billy Harris, hit him right there. How about the offensive line, Errol?
This is a big offensive line. Dave Crust, an All-American candidate, left tackle. In the middle, they're very solid with Chris Gamble at left guard, 285. As you see, Mark Sinlinger, 3-year starter at center, and Bob Cratchit, right guard. Another fine player, Herb Wester, All-American candidate, right tackle.
Stand-up tight end for the Hawkeyes. And they run the draw play. Michigan defense ready. And again, it was Billy Harris, the nose man, and Andy Moeller, number 49. They're a great team leader at that linebacker spot. He relays his father's defensive calls to the rest of the unit out there on the field there.
Good defensive start thus far for the Wolverines. You see right there, Bayless is stopped by Moeller. Harris, nice job. I guarantee you that Hayden Fry has got a lot of tricks up his sleeve. This is a 60-minute game, and we'll see some of them.
Well, here's one of them right here, Coach. Robert Smith splits out, and it's a lone setback at 3rd and 5. Pahulski under fire. First down. He goes to his tight end, who comes out to midfield. Marv Cook, number 84, the junior from West Branch, Iowa. Tony Gant finally brought him down. That's a gain of 26. He was wide open.
Very nice job of scrambling, but here he is. He comes down and comes across the field. As you see, Pahulski is forced out of the pocket, avoids a tackle, and makes a nice play. Actually, the rest of the receivers were covered. Here he comes, right. He's wide open as he comes off the line of scrimmage. But Pahulski is flushed out of the pocket, has the ability to see him throw. Big play for the Hawkeyes.
Era Bayless re-enters the game. He's in the backfield. They split the backs, and they'll run their fullback on first down. And what an opening for Bass. He's inside that 30-yard line that time. Richard Bass, and I want you to take a look at the hole that's opened up here on the right side. This is about the biggest offensive line in college football, and you look at this gap that they get right there. Now Bass, who has replaced the injured David Hudson, Hudson expected to play, he does the rest. But folks, that's that right side over there. That's Sinlinger, the center, helping out with Cratch, the right guard, and huge Herb Wester, 73. And they roll down on that 25-yard gain to the 25-yard line on a 1st and 10. Good-looking drive by the Hawkeyes. Now
Now the second man, Bayless, on the cutback, and again Moeller along with Dieter Herron, 35. So it's 49 Moeller and 35 Herron cutting him off as he comes inside. Well, we've been talking about the defense. Now Mark Messner, perhaps their best defensive rushman, although so far this nose guard, Billy Harris, has played awfully well. Dave Folkertsma played well late last week, and the outside linebacking crew. John Willingham is there. The defensive leader is Andy Moeller. His father is the coordinator here. And Todd Schulte is the other inside man. And outside is Dieter Herron. This is second and six for Pujolski. Bass is the fullback in the eye. They will run Bayless through the left side. He is short of the first down. That was Willingham at 39, the outside linebacker, with Hayden Fry watching. Era?
He's got to be pleased with what he sees. Hayden's team is off a good start.
Now here's that secondary, Garland Rivers. He's superb, and he's a veteran number 13. Also back there, Hicks, his brother, formerly a player with the San Francisco 49ers. Tony Gant is at free safety today, able to play despite an injury. David Arnold, young, and he's going to be a good one, according to the coach. This is third and less than a yard. Here is that power eye formation. Grant Goodman, number 30, he's the back in motion to help out on the blocking, and they didn't need him. Bayless got into the 10 era. This offensive line of the Hawkeyes is something.
That's just the point that I was going to make, Brent. They're really commanding the line of scrimmage. Chris Gamble, Dave Crust on the left side, to the right side of your screen here. You'll see the blocking. Beautiful job of blocking on Schulte right there. And I believe it is, I couldn't quite tell, they're 17. Ivan Hicks had stepped in there and made the play, but the blocking at the point of attack is really good.
Now they've got the ball down to the 10-yard line on this opening drive. That Michigan defense reeling a bit. Now you remember last year, even though Iowa won the game, they did not score a touchdown on this defensive unit. Willingham, number 39, being assisted off the field, and Thiebert, Steve Thiebert, 86, steps in there as his replacement. Moeller, meanwhile, went over to the sideline for a little talk with the coaching staff. He relays the call to the defense. Marshall Cotton, 25, is in there, and now he goes in motion. That gives him an added blocker to run in that direction, and it is simply Bayless. Fine run down to the brink of the goal line before he is finally brought down. Tony Gant made the stop. Era, that left side has become vulnerable, which is the right side of the Michigan defense.
Crosston and Gamble right here at left guard and left tackle, along with a tight end. Watch the blocking combinations here, and the hole open up for Bayless. Beautiful job. Look at that hole. That's picture book stuff right there.
Well, that offensive staff of Hayden Fry's right now sending one substitution after another. The power eye with Goodman, and instead they run past the fullback in behind him for the touchdown. Touchdown for Hayden Fry. The one thing that concerned defensive coordinator Gary Moeller is whether or not Iowa could control his ball on the ground, and they looked awfully good on that first drive.
Brent, that's absolutely correct. I can't believe the way they controlled the line of scrimmage on those running plays. Those were not little holes they were going through. Those were big holes. And, of course, Gary Moeller right there is concerned, obviously.
Outland nails that extra point. Ooh, we haven't been at it long, and the Hawkeyes hit the Wolverines with a 7 spot.
From the end zone, you'll see the power, just a power eye right here. Good blocking, seal blocking by the left side on the ball came out. Let's take another.
Did he get across?
He called that down, but I believe that was a fumble. We could not see from this vantage point except in this replay.
I could tell by the reaction in the end zone that the ball had come free. But looking at it live, I thought he had crossed the plane. I'll tell you what, we're going to take a break. We'll come back and we'll take another look at that play.
We're not a company, but we'll give you a chance to work where there's always a challenge. We'll give you opportunities to learn, to develop, to perfect skills that you thought were beyond your reach. We'll help you build a career that can reward you for the rest of your life. We're not a company, we're your country. We're the Army, the Navy, the Air Force, the Marines. We're the Armed Forces. It's a great place to start.
Hey, Da Vinci, you look wasted.
I've got to present the helicopter, the spiral staircase, and the parachute by 10 o'clock. I'll never get it together.
Lenny, relax. We'll make it look great with this Xerox desktop publisher. The workstation lets you create graphics and mix them with words. Then the laser printer prints everything out laser perfect.
Eat your heart out, Gutenberg.
Desktop publishing from Team Xerox. It brings out the genius in you.
Tomorrow, the New York Giants sack and destroy defense must derail Seattle's dynamic Craig DeLargent connection. Doubleheader action starts with the NFL today on CBS Sports.
Darrell, what do you think?
Well, here is the goal line here. I'll draw it across here. If he broke that plane, you judge for yourself as he comes in here. Bayless, watch. If he breaks that plane, it's a judgment of the official that it's a touchdown. I'm sorry, Richard Bass. Bass, the fullback. Watch right here. Is he across that line? The official ruled that he was, and it's a touchdown.
And there's no way that we can be definitive from that angle. So there will be no spy in the sky instant replay to turn that one around, folks. We can't tell. It's very close. You don't know whether or not he had control. It was an impressive drive nevertheless, and I can hear some of my friends in Iowa City saying, how about last year when they took one away from us? Remember Scott Helverson in the back of the end zone?
Exactly.
Win some and you lose some. George Murphy with the ball teed up, and in the only numbers that matter, the Hawkeyes lead the Wolverines 7-0, and boy, I was so impressed with that offensive line. Oof, they just blew them back. I haven't seen Michigan reeling like that on defense in a couple of years, Harold.
As I pointed out, those were not small holes that they were running through. And the big play, of course, was the pass from Pujolski to Cook on a third down play.
Low kick. Holloway, number 48 at the 5. Coming up the sideline. Nice little move to get beyond the 20. Wraps up the ball there at the 23-yard line. And now we'll see this Michigan offense for the first time, and it's a good one. Jimmy Harbaugh, write him down. He's a Heisman Trophy candidate. Ken Higgins, sure-handed wide man. The burner is Kolasar. He got a couple last week. Jeff Brown, young tight end. And in the backfield, Gerald White can go at fullback or the tail. And speed there in Thomas Wilcher. Look for Jamie Morris to play a lot in that spot. Harbaugh, bring him up in the eye. Two wide receivers to Harbaugh's right, the open side of the field. They run the tailback on a nice counterback. And it squirts out to the 33, and it looks like it could be a first down. And Bo Schembechler crossing this up at the last moment starts Morris on the first play of the game instead of Wilcher.
Watch Jamie Morris cut back and find a daylight to his left as the Hawkeyes flow with the play. There's a nice hold. Nice running by Jamie Morris. He found that they like it.
Giant fans like a relative of his. By the name of Joe Morris. He can scoot, can't he? Second and a yard now for Harbaugh and the Wolverines. If you haven't seen Jim Harbaugh, you're going to like him. He's a real good one. Run that fullback White for the first down to the 35. Let's go downstairs to Pat O'Brien. Pat, what do you got?
All right, Brent, thank you. Earlier, Hayden Fry told me that the busiest guy last 3 weeks has been their trainer, Ed Crowley. What have the last 3 weeks been like? You've got 43 guys on an injured list.
Well, it's been fairly hectic, around the clock almost, 8 o'clock in the morning until about 10:30, 11 o'clock at night. There are approximately 43 athletes injured, and as you know, they have to go to school, and so you have to get their appointments in between classes and in between practices and meetings and so on and so forth. So we're there pretty late at night.
Let's go back to...
Well, I got to tell you, Pat, the offensive line looked pretty healthy to me, big fella. I got to tell you that, okay? Second down at 9. How about taking a look at the offensive line? Huzar out of Chicago. This, of course, the Michigan offensive line. Dames is the left guard. Vitale is the center. Mark Hammerstein, the right guard. And then the big fella, future All-American right there, Jumbo Elliott. Remember him. He's going to be real good. This is second down at 9. Harbaugh to put it up for the first time. Drops it off to Morris. Look at the blockers form for Jamie. Jamie's out to midfield and to the 49-yard line of the Hawkeyes, where he's finally brought down by J.J. Puck. That's a 14-yard gain.
Nice block by Mike Husar. Nice little screenplay. Sets it up well by Harbaugh. Jay, look at him look away. He looks away. Then he dumps the ball off to Jamie. Picks up his blocking in the front. Mike Husar made a nice peelback block. And, of course, he gets a first down. Nice play.
Now, what do you think of Harbaugh as a quarterback? How about, for example, his pro potential?
Well, Bo says it's the best pro prospect that he's ever had here. And beyond being able to throw that ball well, he's a good scrambler.
As the eyes set behind it. They'll run the draw with Morris. And there's a penalty marker down. He has stuffed that midfield right back at the original line of scrimmage, but there was a penalty flag thrown in behind the play as you check some of the scores of the games in progress. I think I caught a glimpse of a Clemson score big over Duke as it went by. That's one of the teams we're going to be covering next week on CBS. They lost their opener to Virginia Tech. But beware of Clemson before this season is over. And that is a top 10 potential team. They made a number of mistakes down the stretch, or they too would be unbeaten this year. And how about your Irish? And speaking of next week,
great.
The Trojans against the Stanford Cardinal. That's the big one out on the West Coast at 12:30 Pacific time. Jack Elway doing a job. And Era, you and I will be there for the big game. This is the big one. You folks all want to see this one. Clemson Tigers, the North Carolina State Wolfpack. I look forward to going down there for a football game. You ever done one down there in Raleigh?
That's one place that I've never been. I've been in most of the stadiums in the entire United States. I've missed the one at Raleigh-Durham.
Well, it was holding against the Wolverines, and so it is first and 20. Iowa leading Michigan 7-0, and Harbaugh with a deep drop. And hits his tight end Brown at the 48-yard line. He had run out of bounds.
Very impressive throw by Harbaugh. He was backing up, threw the ball off balance, as you'll see. Watch him on the back. Watch Harbaugh right here as he throws the ball. You'll see that he's off balance, and he's getting pressure from the left side. So we can get Harbaugh in here. Well, I guess we miss him right there. But you can, he throws the ball off balance and put the ball right on the mark. A perfect throw.
There's
right
Jimmy
here. Now, look, watch this. Completely off balance with a rush.
Boy, that's a nice throw off balance, isn't it? That's something the scouts will look at. Because frequently, you've got to be off balance. Now he sets up, comes back, almost intercepted, and there's a penalty flag thrown. That was Keaton Smiley, number 44, who jumped in there on Morris, and the flag went down immediately.
Well, it looked like he was going after the ball from this vantage point, but they're calling under defense.
That's a big call from referee Tom Quinn in charge of this game here this afternoon.
See if we can get another. Here's a ground level view of it. Smiley steps. Boy, I think he's going after the ball.
You know, I'll tell you though, Era,
that's interference.
But let me tell you something. There might have been contact before we pick it up. You know,
it's possible, but I.
No, I agree with you. I think he was going for the ball, wasn't he, huh?
I really do. I don't think that's.
You think that's a bad call?
I do. I don't make any question about that. I think Keaton Smiley got a bad call there.
First and 10 for the Wolverines. As a result of that penalty.
I don't think you'd get any argument from Keaton either.
Bo Schembechler's not arguing. Hayden Fry not too happy on the far side. Ball to 47. 7-0. Hawkeyes with an early lead. There's the wishbone look for the first time. And Harbaugh runs out of it on the keeper. And he's dangerous too as a runner.
Well, again, the formation, the change to the multiple formation of the wishbone and all these other things that Michigan is doing today makes them a very dangerous offensive team.
Let's take a look at these defensive folks here today for Iowa. Era.
Joe Mott, I think one of the best players I've seen this year again. Outstanding player. Tim Anderson replacing injured Jeff Frost. Big job for him. Dave Hated, the nose man. John Breeze, two-year starter at the other tackle. And Bruce Gear, a very steady performer at the other end.
Perryman helps fill out that backfield as White from the wishbone gets to the 35-yard line, and that's a first down for the Wolverines.
How about introducing the folks to the rest of that team?
Okay, Dan Worth, a big linebacker at 6'4", 236. And the leading tackler on this football team, George Davis, a real contact football player. Ken Sims made two big interceptions in the last two games to save games for the Hawkeyes. Kerry Burt at the strong safety spot, big guy. Kyle Crow moved from quarterback to the free safety, and Keaton Smiley, the hitman.
And remember number 35, Brad Quast. That freshman linebacker will see some action today before this one's over, too. And so back with that wishbone. And Harbaugh sends him out of there to throw down the middle, incomplete. What a nice-looking play that was out of the wishbone.
It was a design out of the wishbone. The fullback went right on through, and you have to commit a number of people. If you'll watch right here, Perriman goes right through and down, and he's open, but Harbaugh just overthrows him right there, right in the seam. Perfect against that defense.
There are where the safeties go on that play.
Safeties came up to try to stop the wishbone, and it put a lot of pressure on that defense. That'll keep it quiet down. It'll quiet down the support and make them run that option a little bit better, I think.
7-16 in the first. Iowa on defense, leading Michigan 7-0. Extra defensive back in this situation. They'll run Morris on the draw against it, and the Hawkeyes defended it very well. And there is Brad Quast, number 35. That young man has got some future there at Iowa.
He's just a freshman, 6'2", 225, number two tackler on the team, runs a 4.6 40. Not bad for a freshman. He'll be around a while.
Now here's what that Iowa defense is up against here on 3rd and 11. Michigan this year has converted 57.3% on third down. That's a testimony to Harbaugh. Let's see what he can get here.
Blitz maybe. Here comes the blitz.
He has time. Pumps it down. Complete. Incomplete, the official rules. I thought for sure that McMurtry, the freshman from Brockton, Mass., had it. And Kenny Sims, number 9, was the corner on the coverage.
You'll see him come right straight down the field here and break in. Watch the blitz come from the linebackers, and Harbaugh avoid it. Right there. He's one-on-one. It looked like he had the ball, as Brent pointed out. He dropped the ball right as he hit the ground. Good call by the official.
Official was right there. When he 53 yards on the field goal by Mike Gillette, the long man. He's got it. One more look at the young man, McMurtry, inside the 5-yard line, coming down with the ball. Sims is right there, and it comes free, no question about it. And then Gillette hits the 53-yard field goal, and Iowa's lead has been reduced to 7-3. We'll be right back. Kenny Sims with that great defensive play. He grew up in East St. Louis, Illinois, one of 13 children. His brother Eddie was shot to death before the start of this football season. He didn't think he would come back and even play football. But his mother said, "You go back, Kenny, and you do the best you can." And I asked him, "Kenny, if you had something to say to your mother today, what would you like to tell her watching this game on television?"
Yeah, that I love her. I don't think I'd tell her that as much as I should. I know she know, and I would just like to tell her and all over the nation that I love her, and I just appreciate her support.
So Llewellyn Sims, your son just did it again. He saved that Michigan State game that we covered a couple weeks ago. Now he knocks the ball free down inside the 5-yard line. You should be very proud of that young man. And Michigan can be very proud of this young man, Mike Gillette. That 53-yard field goal was the longest in Michigan history. Previous record, 52 yards by Bob Bergeron versus the Washington Huskies back in 1984. And it's 7-3 in error right off the top. We got action in this one.
We sure do. This will be a big drive, or I should say a concern for the Michigan defense, because Iowa took it right down the last time.
The same deep men, Harmon and Smith. Harmon says we will down it right there for the touchback. There is a penalty flag down at the 30-yard line. Era, what about this wishbone?
This was the play that almost went for a touchdown for Michigan, where White came right down the seam right here. You got blocking here and coming out of the backfield. These people were fooled, and instead of being a touchdown, it was just slightly overthrown by Harbaugh. You'll see him, White come right straight through. Right there, he's open. Harbaugh tries to lead him right there, just overthrown slightly.
Well, the officials conferring with Andy Moeller, one of the Michigan team captains here, at the 20-yard line as the flag was thrown, as the ball was being fielded by Harmon down in the end zone.
Illegal use of hands on the receiving team, declined.
All right, so that penalty will still leave the ball right there at the 20-yard line as it was declined. Tomorrow, doubleheader day on CBS. Dallas, Philadelphia, plus other regional action. We'll start our coverage at 12:30 Eastern time. Then the big one, the Giants go west to play Seattle. Must be a real fine ball game tomorrow afternoon out there in the Kingdom. Chuck Knox is such a good coach. And Bill Parcells has put the show on the road with the Giants. First and 10. The Hawkeyes with their second possession, and let's watch that offensive line. Bass. A little more vigor on the part of the Wolverine defense that time. Moeller, number 49, one of the tacklers over there.
Well, he started well on the first drive where they stopped Iowa on the first two plays, and then, of course, Pujolski came up with that nice little scramble out to his right and completed the pass that ultimately led to the drive to the score.
There, they get 4 yards. On first down, what would a team like Iowa like to get out of it? I know they'd like to get the distance, let's face it, but is 4 yards good, bad, or how are they set now?
I would think that they'd stay on the ground running the ball. They had such success with their offensive line blocking. They want to get it out of this territory here. Well, they're going double wing here, which is a passing formation.
And then they run Bass off that passing formation era for the first down. Andre McIntyre, 54, gets over on it. You know, that's the second time with the lone setback that they found a wide opening over there on the left. And also, Era, I don't think Hayden has shown this Michigan defense the same formation at the snap 2 times in a row.
They did multiple formations. They do a great job of setting a game plan. And when you go to double wing as they have, you wind up with two receivers on both sides, and you've got to deploy some of the people to protect and cover that.
All the scores coming up on the Prudential College Football Report at halftime. And again, whoa, nice stick that time by McIntyre. Big fella, they've been waiting to come alive here in Ann Arbor. And he did with that tackle.
6'1", 241. He's a great athlete, can really move. And there was a hit there. Watch McIntyre. Here's a ground level view. You'll come to the right side of your picture, number 54. You can see the end of it right there. McIntyre really put a hit on him.
You know, now these Hawkeyes have rushed for, well, a loss of a yard there. So 64 yards here already this afternoon. McIntyre out of the Chicago area, and a lot of his tackles this year have been 5 or 6 yards downfield, and he's such a big talented fellow, they want him to step into the hole like he did there. Lone setback. Pujolski, straight back. Left sideline, and Morrow, trying to keep it in bounds, loses control of the ball.
Boy, he tried to keep it in. I mean, he did a nice job there with his feet.
It was interesting to watch one of the drills there that the receivers had for the Hawkeyes before the game. They work on this on the sideline.
We sure do. Let's see where the ball was overthrown. He couldn't stay with it. Boy, the ball was too far out for him to keep them both in or keep his foot in there. It was on the line. But a nice attempt.
So players continue to shuttle in and out for Hayden Fry on that far sideline. This is a 3rd and 11 for the Hawkeyes. Straight back, wanted Morrow and threw inside. Garland Rivers was right with the receiver there.
Well, I'm surprised that Pujolski wouldn't try to go for the first down. He threw a quick out pattern, was well covered, but it would have only gained about 7 yards. Wouldn't have been enough for the first down they'd been forced upon anyway.
Kostrabala, the left-footed punter. He's like a one-step punter. He'll hit low punts, and he will get the gosh darndest bounces you've ever seen sometime. He's a good one. Now, Kolasar fields that at the 37. He's got great speed, but he cannot break away. They could not get free from Senlinger. 33-yard punt. So when you come back, there will be 4:21 left in the first. Iowa by 4 points. We'll be right back.
Today's Equitable has new ideas in financial planning that can help pay for the home you live in or build you a vacation home. Today's Equitable, your key to financial opportunity. Our new ideas not only protect you, but can help send your kids to college. Today's Equitable, your key to financial opportunity. Our agents and financial planners can show you new ways to make high returns on your money.
We are the Equitable.
Your key to financial opportunity.
Lean on me when you're not strong, and I'll be your friend. I'll help you carry on, for it won't be long till you're gonna need somebody to lean on.
When you need a truck to lean on, nothing works like a Chevy truck.
Women in politics. Running in more state and local races, is today's campaigner building a power base in her own backyard? The story tonight on the CBS Evening News with Bob Sheeper.
There's the coach, the coach, the coach, Bo Schembechler. And last week, well, he was kind of close to a camera down there, and he said shucks, and his mother called him this week and said, Bo, come on, you can't be talking like that on network TV. So I said, Bo, what would you like to tell Mama Schembechler this afternoon?
Well, I'd say Mother's CBS encroached on my privacy in that ball game, and I apologize if I said anything that offended you.
Encroach indeed. All right. So he's going to be more careful today, Mr. Schembechler, until things don't go his way in the fourth quarter. All right, first and 10 now. Kolesar comes in motion for the Wolverines, and they run Perriman, and boy, that's a fine tackle over here by Danny Wirth, number 46. Aerith. Bo Schembechler was a head coach down in Miami, your alma mater. Then he worked for you at Northwestern. And what kind of a fella is he? I think the press views him a little bit sometimes as a little woody, referring to Hayes.
Well, he's a disciplinarian, but he's a fun guy. I think they've got him tapped wrong when it comes to his overall personality. He's as we know, I mean, what a great mood he was in the last 2 days, you know. Now, if he loses, he doesn't like that. I mean, you don't want to be around him.
Yeah, we don't have to be around him when he loses. We get out of town, run for the airplanes, right? Second down and 10. High formation for the Wolves. Nice fake by Harbaugh. Really froze the defense and bought some time on the roll. Dropped. And that's the tight end over there. And Dan Wirth, the linebacker, was with Brown.
Had an awful lot of time to throw the ball that time. Coverage was fairly good.
Yeah, that was just a great fake, and then he rolled his pocket more or less out there to the right side. You know, Jimmy Harbaugh has not received a lot of Heisman hype. That's deliberate here at Michigan. When Jim came to school, his father, a football coach, said to Bo, you know, he said, Bo, Jimmy's always been kind of interested in his individual statistics, and I know that's not going to be the case with you, and it has not been. They stress total team effort. If he gets Heisman support, so much the better, but it should come as a result of what he does. On third down, Harbaugh under fire, throws high. Oh, Sims came in there on Kolesar and did the number again.
What a play that Sims made again. Heard that he was wide open. You see Jokic come in motion across the backfield, and here's Harbaugh from an end zone shot. Now watch Sims recover while the ball is in the air. Right there. Knock it away from Kolesar. Boy, that's a nice piece of work. Sims is, he's just a heck of a defensive back.
Here's Monty Robbins, the punter, number 43. And Peter Marciano set to return it. Yes, he is the nephew of the late, great heavyweight champion Rocky Marciano.
Great punt by Robbins. I mean, that's beautiful. He drives him to the nine. Marciano is popped down by Garland Rivers. A 53-yard punt and a 7-yard return. We'll be right back. It's 7-3 Iowa.
Next Saturday, it's a battle to stay in the Rose Bowl fight when John Kay launches the Stanford Cardinal in flight against the Trojans of USC next Saturday on CBS Sports.
Well, we're back at Michigan Stadium. It's 7-3 Iowa with the lead, and we're 3:14 left here in the opening quarter. And Coach Eric Parsegan, anything surprise you yet about this ball game?
Well, the thing that surprises me has been the ability of Iowa's offensive line to command the line of scrimmage. The first quarter isn't over yet, but that was a very impressive drive. And that's one of the things I think that if Michigan expects to win this football game, they're going to have to shore up.
What about the adjustments that Coach Moeller made?
Well, it's a little too early to tell. They did have a good second series. But Iowa is a dangerous football team. They've been very impressive as far as I'm concerned.
So for the Hawkeyes in that impressive line Era told you about, this will be a first and 10 at the 16-yard line. And Tom Pahulski with one setback, and Bass will move in behind him. And he runs Bass out to the 20-yard line. Volkertsma made the stop, number 93, tripped him up. Hey, we got an update. Let's go to Jim Nance in New York. Jim?
All right, Brent, at Chapel Hill, the Tar Heels fumbled on the Wolfpack 2. Seven plays later, Eric Kramer to Naz Worthen, 37-yard touchdown with a minute to go. And now the Heels have come right back. They're on the Wolfpack 12 with 15 seconds left. Let's go back to Brent and Era.
Oh, what a good one that is. And that Naz Worthen, he has been their leading receiver all week, and that's a fellow we'll be looking at down there in Raleigh. North Carolina State and Clemson next Saturday. And now there's movement on both sides, a lot of jumping around, and we'll see if the offensive line pulled them off or what the situation was there. There was a 4-yard gain on that play. You know, Pahulski is a great story. He took over a couple weeks ago, and I asked him, what's it going to be like to play before this huge crowd here at Michigan Stadium?
Well, again, it's going to be a great thrill. You know, I've watched Michigan play, and, you know, just last year the game was just a fantastic game. I had to sit out on the sidelines and watch, but knowing I'm going to be starting, you know, it's just another great thrill, and it's a big game this weekend. You know, it has the possibility to decide, you know, who might win the Big Ten championship, and I'm just going to go out there and give it my best this week.
Started the season as their fourth-string quarterback, held on extra points because of the injury to Mark Vlasic. He moved into the starter's spot 2 weeks ago, defeated Michigan State. He was spectacular in the early going for Hayden Fry of that game against the Spartans. And Hayden sends the play out with one of his tight ends to the offense. Marv Cook will deliver it to Pahulski, and it'll be called in the huddle. There was no flag on that play. Would you like to explain that one to me, Mr. Parsegan? You're my expert on officiating.
Well, we had one just like that last week.
Swallowed six flags that time.
Yeah.
Second and six. Off a play fake, here's David Hudson. First time he's played in a while. And he could be a huge force as he comes out to the 35-yard line. That's a 16-yard run by Hudson, and Hayden slips him into the game at just the right time.
He's a man also. There's a guy that can go all the way. The left offensive guard makes a great block. See him coming to our right here. It's a little bit of a here. They fake to the left halfback, then give it to Hudson, who's lined up at the right halfback. Look at that hole right there. This is what I was talking about, that they're really commanding that line of scrimmage and making great holes for their backs.
Hudson, the lead back for Bayless, and Bayless is swatted down at the 30-yard line by Willingham, number 39, who came in from behind, brought him down. This will be a second down and 11 after that loss of a yard. And two players coming off from the sideline, so the shuttling and the lineup changes, the different formations continue here on the part of the Hawkeyes.
Fry uses his personnel very effectively.
That's Robert Smith. He lines him up in the tailback, and he moves him out to a flanker. Hudson on the draw, hammered by Billy Harris, the nose guard, leading the way.
Billy Harris is 6 foot, 270 pounds, and very quick. He looped to the left and was in that secondary just as quick as the back was. If you take a look at it, watch the nose man right there, 56, go right around the center, Sindlinger, and right in on the play right now. Great work.
Now, he hit him first down there, yeah. And then Volkertsma came in there, 93, to help out. But I'll tell you, this nose guard is giving the Iowa center all he can handle right now. They're going to need some blocking help. It's third and 14. over the middle, complete for the first down. They go to the tight end that time, Marv Cook, and it's a 24-yard gain.
Great throw by Pahulski, a beautiful throw. Looked like he was covered. Cook hung onto the ball with a doggone good throw. You just watch him. He comes right down the straight down the field here, right in the seam. Looks like he's covered well. That's Cook. And watch how he hangs onto that ball with a lot of contact. Here the linebacker is running back with him. Look how Pahulski puts that ball right there. There's the tackle. Dieter Herron, 35. But not until that ball is caught.
Now Cook has caught two passes for 50 yards already in this game. And here's Hudson slanting to the right side and cannot break free. The second man, Andre McIntyre, number 54. But again, I'll tell you, Billy Harris was in there to disrupt. And we have come to the end of the first quarter. Iowa scored the first time it handled the ball on the opening possession. Michigan comes back. Great defensive play by Ken Sims. And the Wolverines settle for a 53-yard field goal. We'll be right back after this message and a word from your local station.
Pat O'Brien back in Michigan Stadium on the Iowa sideline. And to give you an idea how big this game is, this is the first time the Iowa band has traveled in 20 years. Morgan Jones, how come they're here?
Well, we considered it to be a very, very big and a very, very important band event, a very, very important football event. We fell well into our schedule, so here we are, and we're just having a great time.
And Brett Nera, you and I worry about carrying our hand luggage. How would you like to travel with 15 tubas anyway? Strike up the band for us, will you, Morgan?
One thing would make a lot of noise, wouldn't we?
It's great to have here, isn't it? The sounds of college football. You'll see it every Saturday on CBS. Second and 10. The ball is at the Michigan 44. Smith in motion. Pahulski's got a man wide open over there on the far sideline, and he's inside the 25-yard line. He slipped Bayless out of the backfield and hit him, and it's a 21-yard gain. Great pass patterns the Hawkeyes are running here.
This is basically the same thing that they did to Michigan last year. They fake a run action to the right. That's Hudson, number 20. Now Pahulski turns and looks back to the right, and you'll see him wide open. They have one man drive off, which is Bobby Smith, drive off, and of course then Bayless trails in behind him.
Era, I think the audience got a good view of that offensive line pass protecting. I mean, Cratch, 6'4", 280, Wester, 6'8", 285 on that right side. Nobody was getting through. Pahulski and the Hawkeyes are inside the 25-yard line. They continue to show one set after another. Hudson hammers his way inside the 20-yard line. You can see what the Hawkeyes have lost with him out of the lineup because of that quadricep muscle which exploded over there in Iowa City. What a superb college football player he is.
6'2 and 230 and can really move. He just bled that yardage. He was stopped at the line of scrimmage and came out with a 5-yard gain.
We told him to smile during his headshot yesterday because he didn't get it. He said, no way.
He wouldn't, boy. I mean,
I don't think he's smiling on any linebackers either, is he?
Got his game face on.
Second down and 5. Smith goes in motion. Throw him a little pro set that time. They drop the screen off to Hudson. He bangs down close to the 10-yard line. That's going to be close to another first down. Tony Gant, 14 down there. And, Errol, what about the way the Hawkeyes have got this defense reeling again?
They've got such a variety of formations and plays. They really have gotten the Michigan Wolverines off balance. Here comes that sweep action again. Now Hudson slips right underneath it for the screen right there, number 20. It was the same action as before, but this time, instead of throwing downfield, they put it in Hudson's hands on the screen, and he runs it down to the 12-yard line.
So Pahulski, 4 of 6 for 79 yards. Has this first down at the 12-yard line, the power eye, and Hudson is hammered there at the 10-yard line, moving in behind the right side. Well, North Carolina State and North Carolina. Jim, what happened in that game? How'd it end?
Well, Brent, it was a wild finish. We told you North Carolina was driving. Here, Mark May to Quentin Smith. The touchdown makes it 35-34. Dick Crum calls for the two. Going for the win, North Carolina throws to Dave Truitt. But watch, the knee is down. So a big win for the Wolfpack, 35-34. Let's go back to Brent Nera.
All right, thanks, Jim. What a way for that one to end. We'll see the Wolfpack next week against Clemson. Clemson rolling this afternoon, so those two will be coming in on a bit of a high. There's a little jam up there, and McIntyre, 54, comes right in over the top. Andre McIntyre starting to play the way they want here at Michigan.
That looked like some confusion there in the backfield, was there?
No, there's misdirection play. They're going to fake here, a little tackle trap. You see there?
Oh, I see.
You see him fake and then come back. But look at McIntyre right there on top of it.
The defense jammed up the hole. That's what I saw. They had forced Bayless back into the cut line when they penetrated from the right side of that defense. And that's why he kind of swerved back outside there for about a step or two. This is third and 10. Quick drop, incomplete. Cook doesn't hold on. And that time it was Mike Flagg who was the intended receiver, the other tight end.
You know, what they were trying to do there was the pass was no more than 3 or 4 yards, and there were people around it. Let's see, we can see here, just a quick throw right there. I mean, it would have been, at best, 3 or 4 yard gainer.
Andy Moeller had the coverage, and Rob Houghton in to attempt a 29-yard field goal, the magic number from a year ago. 29 yards did it. 7-3, Hawkeyes with the lead. Kick is up, and Houghton puts three more on the board against the Wolverines. Schimbeckler will be awfully glad to see that young man graduate. Got him again. It's 10-3, and it's a 7-point Hawkeye lead here in the second quarter. And Hayden Fry's coaching staff deserves a lot of credit for the game plan that they have put together here this afternoon. Houghton puts the three up on the board, and we'll be right back.
There was that third down play right here. This is Moeller here and Flagg here. He just moves about 2 or 3 yards. Moeller's right on him. Pajolski here may have made the mistake and thrown the ball way too soon because there's no chance of making a first down. They've got to go to the 2-yard line. You can see right here, he's not really pressured. He just throws it right there, and Moeller is right there on top of him.
And there is Andy Moeller, the young man who done such a fine job of calling defensive signals for his father, and that's not easy to play for your dad in any situation. I know you're well aware of that, Era. You had your son playing for you, and you were too tough on him.
Yeah, I was a little tough on him.
Well, near the conclusion of this game, Era and I will be participating in a 16-year tradition, selecting a Chevrolet Most Valuable Player of the Game from each of these teams. Chevrolet donates a $1,000 scholarship to the General Scholarship Fund of each school. I want to go back on your son for a moment. He's down in Tucson, Arizona, an orthopedic surgeon down there, so you didn't ruin him too much, Coach, by not letting him play enough at Notre Dame.
No, I didn't, but he's done a great job. I guess he saw all those injuries we were having on the field that Hayden Fry has had and decided it'd be a good job to repair all those folks.
He's got that. It is 10-3, Iowa over Michigan. We've got 12 minutes to go here. Murphy with one of those ground ball kickoffs. Holloway fields it at the 10. Out close to the 30-yard line. Down there at the 29. Well, let's go back and get you up to date on that ACC action. There's the one you just looked at from New York. 35-34, the Wolfpack over the Tar Heels. And Clemson rolling 28-3 over Duke there in the fourth quarter. And 3:30 Eastern time, we will be covering the Clemson North Carolina State game. Most of the country will be watching this one, and this really should be a dandy. USC and the Stanford Cardinal. I think the Pac-10 is probably the most competitive overall of all the conferences in the country this year. And I hope that one turns into one of those wild 38-35 Donnybrooks for you next week. So they run the fullback right straight ahead up the middle, and Gerald White is popped as he comes across by John Breeze, 57.
Looked like Breeze veered down to the inside. Looked like it was a pretty good hole there, but he closed it up in a hurry.
Errol, what these two teams do statistically last week in Iowa, or last year at Iowa City?
It was unbelievable. It certainly would make the Wolverine fans nervous. Michigan only had 9 first downs and 182 yards, while Iowa had 26 first downs, 422 yards in the first quarter stats. Makes it just about the same as it was a year ago.
Well, Harbaugh needs a big play here. He's 2 of 6 for 22 yards. He drops off the screen to White. Out to the 38-yard line, and that could be short of the first down. Had to get out to the 39, and there is an injured player down on the field, and that is Tim Anderson, number 68. Now, he replaced the All-American, Jeff Grost, who did not make the trip, left home in Iowa City because of an injury.
This play was well set up. It's a screen. Look at Harbaugh look the play off. From up here in the booth, I thought it was going to be a big play, but the response by the Iowa defense closes it down, holds it to a shorter gain. They didn't pick up the blockers. You see number 11, Rich Schmidt, coming in there. A strong safety makes a nice play on it.
And Schmidt held him short of that first down. We're going to have an injury timeout, and while we do, we'll break away. And when you come back, it'll be 3rd and 1. We'll be right back. Well, that ankle injury there on Anderson is apparently inside right there where the trainer is touching. See that right down there in that bone, the inside, the left ankle. And we'll see if they can get that taped up securely enough and get him back, because they really need him. Now it is 3rd and 1. They'll come from the wishbone. Perriman, Morris, and White are behind Harbaugh. And they come straight ahead for the first down with Perriman.
They read that right behind his center that time. Nose man Hake veered to the short side of the field, and a good job of running there by Bob Perriman. Look right here. Watch the center. Watch, he runs behind the center. Hake, number 64, goes all the way to the field and picks up the first down.
Era, that center is John Vitale. He's 6'1", 267. He's a junior out of Detroit. He played at De La Salle High School, and he opens the way for Mr. Perriman, who's a senior from Buzzards Bay, Massachusetts. Tolisar in motion. And on first down, oh, what a hit. Jamie Morris was coming, and Myron Kepi, who just stepped off the Hawkeye bench, he has delivered a message with that play, and what a contribution he makes stepping in there for Tim Anderson.
Well, that really was a great play. He just steps right up in there and makes great contact.
Sometimes all you need, Coach, is a chance.
He was really warmed up. You see him right here, number 77.
Boom. Over there beating on his teammates on the sideline or something over there to get ready. Second and 11. Tolisar switches over to a wing on the right. Very dangerous. Goes back in motion. Penalty markers are down. They drop it off to Morris. And Morris tackled at the 44-yard line. But there were penalty flags on both sides of the line of scrimmage that time. And Jeff Brown, the tight end, may have picked his hand up at the line of scrimmage, Coach.
I think that's right. I think it was on Michigan. Well, and you've got 99 Richard Pryor down.
Another injured player. Hayden Fry said he'd never seen anything like this. Irish roll. Boston College gets by. Unbeaten Alabama up there in Tennessee. Nebraska also unbeaten. Got a lot of unbeaten, untied teams this year. There's another one. Penn State headed for that showdown coming up against Alabama. Auburn's done a great job with a passing quarterback this year, Jeff Berger. Wonder if Pat Sullivan, their former Heisman Trophy winner, has had something to do with that. He's down there as one of their offensive coaches. And Clemson, a comer this year. SMU, even though they're not eligible to go to the Cotton Bowl, they're playing pretty well, and they're being stopped this afternoon. Navy over Penn, and Florida beats Rutgers. Been a tough year for the Gators. Well, Harvard comes through against Dartmouth. They lead them by a point, and Yale running it up on Columbia there in the fourth quarter. And another one of the Big Ten, Michigan State, trying to get back on the winning track down there in Champaign. This is a very meaningful game for both those teams, and Wisconsin leads at Dyke Stadium in Evanston. Kansas State way ahead of Kansas in the fourth quarter of that game. You get all the information from Jim Nance. That's coming up on the Prudential College Football Report. 9:45 to go, and Pryor being helped off to the sideline here for Iowa. So they must treat still another injured player and get another substitute into the game. Here's 3rd and 10.
penalty flag was thrown. You also heard a whistle sound. The umpire stepped into the middle, and one of the linesmen threw the flags.
Dead ball. I think
Mike Dames, the left guard, looked like he may have moved, either that or Mark Hammerstein, one of the two.
Sort of bogged down and gotten sloppy here for a while.
Two.
This is third and 15 for Harbaugh. There'll be five defensive backs on the field that go to the nickel. Expecting Harbaugh and Michigan to put it up as Jim studies that unit. This is Higgins moving down there, bottom of your screen. Good protection. Receivers recovered, and Harbaugh steps out of bounds at the 45-yard line. That's a first down. Jim Harbaugh knew where he had to go, and that's a 16-yard gain.
And that's the dimension that he gives this Wolverine team. No one open. The coverage is perfect. He knows where the first down marker is. And he takes off with the football, heads for the sideline, and gets just enough for the first down. That gives you that fourth running back in the backfield, Brent.
Bo Schembechler will put the wishbone back in behind Harbaugh on this first and 10 with the ball at the 45. And Perriman bolts inside of the 40-yard line. Good first down running play by the Wolverines, with Dave Haight, 64, tripping him up, and that's why he went down on the carpet here at Ann Arbor.
Picked up pretty good yardage on that play, didn't he?
Sure did. Gives him a second down and three off a 7-yard gain, and those injuries will start to take its toll here pretty soon on the Hawkeyes. You start to lose All-Americans like Jeff Drost, and then his backup, then Pryor gets banged up. On the option, Iowa pounces on the ball. A big turnover by the Wolverines.
That may have been a big mistake by Jamie Morris. It looked like he wanted to throw the ball to the trailing back, and Jamie Morris went to the left instead of to the right.
There's the man who recovered, Haight. He pounced on the ball there at the 48-yard line. And there was nobody here when he pitched it, Arrow. Why don't you go ahead and diagram it?
You see right here is Jamie Morris. Now the fullback will come in like he's supposed to, and the lead back, and Harbaugh will come down the line with the option, but watch Jamie Morris, the left halfback, the trailing back, go the wrong way. Now Harbaugh's looking to throw the ball, and no one's there.
He sure did break the wrong way. So it's first and 10, and a mental blunder results in a turnover, and Harbaugh is probably saying, I wish I had looked. You know, he didn't give it a long look to make sure somebody was there either, did he? Now they run the draw, and it's Bayless. Boy, he's a gutty little back. Boy, you know that?
He is.
We've got some injuries over there, and Pat O'Brien, what's the status over there on the Hawkeye bench right now?
All right, Ben, first of all, Tim Anderson has, as you said, an inside injury to his left ankle. He will be out definitely till the half. They're going to wait on him. Ed Crowley talking to him there. Richard Pryor, you can see, is in a lot of pain. They're icing up almost exactly the same injury. He said he felt something pop, though, and that is not a good sign. They'll both be out until at least the halftime, and they'd like to get these guys back in. From the traveling hospital, let's go back upstairs to Brent.
All right, Pat, thank you. Richard Bass at fullback for the Hawkeyes. Pahulski, pump fake, going deep down the right side. Got a man open, incomplete. Boy, he busted Mara off that pump fake, era.
Boy, he had him. He gave him the pump fake and laid it out there. He was just overthrown a shade. Morrow just comes running right up the field, gets the pump fake up at the top here, comes down and breaks down to the inside. Let's take a look here. But what does it here is the pump fake by Pahulski. We can get that. There it is. There's the pump fake. He turns and goes to the out and then comes back down right here. He's open. But Pahulski just overthrows it.
Boy, you got your hands full as a defensive coordinator against this Hawkeye bunch. Iowa is 3 of 5 on third down so far today, and this is 3rd and 8 for Pahulski. Split backs. Under fire. Incomplete. was Marv Cook, the tight end. John Willingham had come through, number 39, had a direct shot at him. And Paholski, under fire from Willingham, got the ball off, and it was incomplete. Take another look at it, Coach.
See, here comes the blitz from the right corner, right there. Willingham, 39, loses him. Paholski gets rid of that ball. Almost got a completion there to Cook. Good reaction by Paholski.
There's Tuscarbala. Boy, he knocks it out of bounds on the far sideline, inside the 10-yard line. Isn't he a fine punter, huh? That's a 36-yard punt and no return. 7:35, and we'll be right back. Well, we're back at Michigan Stadium, and Jim Harbaugh has thrown for a total of 40 yards so far in the first half, and Coach's longest pass is only 14 yards. What do you think Jimmy should do here for the Wolverines?
Well, there's been a lot of screen passes thrown, short balls. I think that the strong suit of this Michigan team is the ability to throw to Kolsar and Jokic. Big plays. They did that last week, and that's been good for them. And I would think when they get in a little better field position, we'll see that.
Well, right now, field position terrible for the Wolverines. They're inside the 10. So they're 91 yards away here at 7:35. And Thomas Wilcher comes into that backfield for the first time. Jamie Morris taken out as the result of that mental blunder you picked up on, Coach. And there's Wilcher. He gets about a yard to the 10. And Dave Haight, that nose guard, snaps him down right there. And his brother, number one draft choice of the New York Jets, been slowed by injuries. He'll be coming off that injured list. Dave's brother may even see some action, I suppose, on Monday night against the Denver Broncos. So it'll be second and nine. And would you go long here, or would you still sit on it?
Well, I think they can go long anytime they want, as far as Harbaugh is concerned. The important thing is for them to read the coverages properly and get into the open seams, which they did a week ago.
Well, they go to the wishbone, and they return Morris to the lineup, and Harbaugh will throw out of the formation over the middle, and he overthrew his man.
It's not easily done when you get Jokic 6'8". I mean, you got to throw it up there pretty high. Harbaugh had plenty of time, but he just overthrows the ball. You see Jokic come into the picture from your right side. It's off the wishbone. The protection is good until finally right there. There's the ball to Jokic. Now, you're looking at a guy 6'8", so you know how high that ball was. Another look from behind Harbaugh. What he sees, protection is good. Finally gets a little pressure from the left side. Now, there's the throw to Jokic right there.
And as a result, it's this play, third and nine. Under fire. He doesn't get this one off. He's hit at the goal line. And it'll depend on what the referee elects. The Hawkeyes are signaling safety down there.
He marked it at about the 1 yard line, 1 foot yard, 1 foot line.
Now, Myron Kepi, 77, led the away, and Joe Mott, number 97, cleaned up on him.
Told you about that Joe Mott. Here's an end zone shot of it at ground level. Right there is 97 Mott. I'm telling you, this guy is a football player.
Now, very tough punt for Monty Robbins. He'll be standing near the end line. Almost completely out of the end zone. Look at his feet. Any kind of a rush, and he may have to take the safety if they bottle him up. He gets it out of there in beautiful fashion to Marciano, standing at midfield. Marciano to the 44-yard line, a 49-yard punt with a 6-yard return. That is some job by Robbins, Era.
That really is. I mean, you're backed up right into your own end zone.
Go back to that third down play. I mentioned that it was close to a safety, and he was stopped back here. Watch Mott, 97. Gerald White trying to hold him up, and Kepi came through and really busted up the play, and that was close to being a safety back there.
Well, Kepi had him first down around the legs, and of course the referee judged that it was at the 1 yard line. Then he was knocked back into the end zone, and I think he marked that properly.
So it's a first and 10 for Paholski and the Hawkeyes. Hudson getting nowhere. Hawkeyes lead Michigan 10-3. We have 5:33 to go. Era?
Brent, it appears that the Wolverines have done a little better job of shutting down the run, but they have been vulnerable to the passing game. There have been receivers open, and Pujolski overthrew on that one play. So we'll expect probably some kind of a pass here and see whether or not they continue to have open receivers.
Kevin Harmon checks into that backfield along with Hudson. Robert Smith is number two. He's in motion. Pujolski comes underneath incomplete. Pass was underthrown, and he slipped Kevin Harmon out earlier in the game for a gain on that pattern down the sideline, and that time he was covered.
He got a lot of pressure from Billy Harris and David Folkertsman. Came in there and made him throw before he wanted to throw, and that made the difference. You'll watch Harris. There's Folkertsman right there, 93. There comes Harris on the other side. That's the pass defense you want right there.
Pujolski has been incomplete on his last four, and Kevin Ringer, number 33, goes in motion. And they bring him back the other way off the motion, and it does not fool Eric Campbell. Number five makes a big defensive play for the Wolverines.
Hardest defensive play in football, that open field tackle against the great back. And Eric Campbell pulled it off right there, 5'10", 171, on a big play. There he deals the ball off. Now watch number five, Eric Campbell, come up here, open field tackle, hang on to that right leg, and bring him down and force the punt.
Castrobala punting again for the Hawkeyes. Kolasar again lets it roll. This time it went into the end zone, but barely. It was headed for that coffin corner. Bounced in. 47-yard punt. All right, you'll come back. Jim Harbaugh and Michigan will have the ball. There'll be 4:11 to go, and the Wolverines are trailing the Hawkeyes 10-3.
Next Saturday, it's a battle to stay in the Rose Bowl fight when John Kay launches the Stanford Cardinal in flight against the Trojans of USC next Saturday on CBS Sports.
We are back here at a sold-out Michigan Stadium. How about a little memory lane? Wasn't long ago. Temple against East Carolina. Paul Palmer, have you seen him in action? Touchdown runs from 2 yards out for the Owls. Then he was really warmed up, and he hauled one 78 yards for the touchdown. Now, all told, he would carry the ball 43 times for 349 yards, and all-purpose yardage, 417 yards. Oh, he wasn't done scoring either. 20 yards out, and that 417 all-purpose yards ties the NCAA record. Nice going, Paul Palmer of the Temple Owls. He's a good one, isn't he? Here it's Jim Harbaugh and the Wolverines of Michigan trailing Iowa, and on a first down, Harbaugh finally under duress will step out of bounds. That was Myron Kepi who put him on the run. And is there a penalty marker on that far side area? I couldn't tell.
Quite see whether there's a flag thrown.
Yes, there was.
Personal foul.
That'll be a first down for Michigan. Take a look at this, Aaron, and see if you can pick it up.
He's scrambling. Let's see if he was hit when he was out of bounds. Great coverage by the Hawkeyes on this play. I was looking downfield. No wonder Harbaugh did not throw the ball. Everybody was covered. He finally flushes out. He's still looking downfield, still looking. Then he decides he's going to head for that sideline. I don't know. That's pretty thin right there. I mean, he didn't take a shot at him. He was going in the motion of the throw.
He was out of bounds, though. Bruce Gear shoved him. I don't know that you can do that once you cross that out of bounds line, can you?
Well,
you protect
the momentum was at the sideline. Pretty close.
Talking like a linebacker. First and 10. Harbaugh runs the draw on first down. He handed off, and Morris came right into the arms of Joe Mott,
and Rick Schmidt. Here, I've got a question about this punt formation. Castrovalla is so close to the line of scrimmage. Isn't this an easier punt to block than the where he stands way back?
Now look at this solid blocking here. No one's going to penetrate. You've got to come from the outside. The kicker is only about 10 yards, and he kicks that ball, and it's a much safer punt. The coverage isn't as good, though.
Here it is, second and two, 3:27 left in the first half. There's that wishbone. And it's Perriman. First down to the 44-yard line. Dave Haight, 64, the nose man, bringing him down there. Well, we showed you what Paul Palmer did last week in our memory lane, and here this afternoon, boy, he's on fire, isn't he? 29-13 over Virginia Tech and 227 more yards, 43 carries, and he busts across that 100 or that 1,000 yard mark, becomes the first running back this year.
I didn't gain that many yards in a whole season.
On to first down from the wishbone, Harbaugh keeping it. Eric, tell me about a quarterback in that situation when he fumbles and it has been recovered by Iowa. Didn't he expose himself to something like that?
Well, he did, but by the same token, he should have given the ball to the fullback from up here.
Exactly.
Looked like the fullback came clean on the play. Fumbles in about the same spot as the last one was, and you see the turnovers now. And we talked about this earlier, that the turnovers could make the difference in this game. He's mad at himself. Let's take another look here from an end zone shot. And see, if he'd have given the ball to the fullback right there, he'd still be running. Now he follows the fullback in. I don't know. That can't see when that ball came out, but he must have still been on his feet, but it didn't look like it. You can see Bo talking to him right there.
So Pahulski and the Hawkeyes come up. Ball's at the 45, and they've got 247, and Pahulski to throw on first down, going deep down that right sideline for Morrow, and Garland Rivers intercepts it. Garland Rivers is out at the 8-yard line, and that's the first time today that Iowa has turned it over, but it's still a long haul for the Wolverines.
That's as good as a punt there, though, on that interception. They've got the ball at their own 8-yard line. The only thing that they were denied was a couple of plays. They went for the home run and didn't get it. He just goes for the home run on this play, tries to beat him deep, comes all the way down. Garland Rivers is there, and it's as good as a punt in this situation, with the exception of the fact, as I pointed out there, is they missed just two downs. He waited right there. He should have gone on. Morrow stopped, anticipating Pahulski throwing the ball underneath the coverage. Pahulski had already released it.
Michigan defense has gave up that touchdown on the opening drive. It's up to the offense, and Perriman busts out close to a first down. Had to get out to almost the 19-yard line. He's got it. He gets 11 yards, and Kyle Crow, 18, the free safety, brings him down. So along with Ara Parsegan, I'm Brett Musburger. We're live from Michigan Stadium, Ann Arbor, Michigan. Iowa scored, took the opening drive, and punched it in for a touchdown. Michigan kicked the field goal, and then the Hawkeyes came back with a field goal. There's a penalty marker down by one of the linesmen. And we stand at 10-3 here in the first half. Jim Nance will be coming up at halftime. Have scores and highlights for you from around the country. A lot of bowl scouts are checking this one out here.
Dead ball. Ball starts. Awesome.
That's a third one, Brent. That's 15 yards that Michigan has had. I don't know whether or not there's some mix-up in the signals that are being called. There's Bo. And, of course, there's Hayden. And sometimes you will respond to the defense's check signals rather than your own cadence.
And as a result, Harbaugh looking at a first and 15. Ball is back on the Michigan 15. Straight back, goes long, wants Kolasar, and battling for it, Iowa comes up with it.
What a great play on that far side by Keaton Smiley, number 44. Spectacular interception. Dueling Kolesar for the ball, and Smiley comes away for the Hawkeyes.
His third interception of the year. As a matter of fact, that Hawkeye defense, everyone in that starting secondary has intercepted two balls. The coverage has been exceptional. Harbaugh goes for the bomb this time to Kolesar, and they've hit this a number of times in the last 2 years. There's Kolesar waiting, but look at that play. Smiley reaches up with his left hand, deflects the ball, and hangs on for the interception. Great play.
Take a look at him, and as he's going down, he still focuses on the ball and pulls it right in, and that is the third Michigan turnover here in the first half. 2:16 to go. Smith slotted on the left for Bohalski, and they hand to Hudson. And he bangs to the 47-yard line. Garland Rivers, 13, helping out. Clemson with another win. And Minnesota holds on against Indiana and wins a two-pointer, and so they stay tied for the lead in the Big Ten anyhow. Here we've got 1:55, first half. It's 10-3. Hawkeyes with the ball and the lead. Kevin Harmon at the tail. He has it behind Hudson. And he is across midfield. And that could be another first down, and it is, with Moeller and McIntyre, the two linebackers there to bring him down. Era, thinking about the first half, what jumps out is the way the Iowa defense has played against the Michigan offense.
They've played very well. I've been impressed with their coverage. There are very few and seldom receivers that are open. And Michigan has tried to flood with three people. They've tried to split with three people. But the coverage has been exceptional.
And they have held the Wolverines to 93 yards.
That's just exactly what it was a year ago. 182 yards total offense for the game.
Bohalski throws to Robert Smith. Coming to the near sideline, and he can turn it on. Stepped inside that 30-yard line, got down to the 27. Tony Gamp, 14, over there when he went out of bounds. That's a gain of 20 yards for the young man.
Sneaky little move there by Bobby Smith there. He comes off the line of scrimmage. You'll see him. He'll come into your picture on the right-hand side. Then he'll kind of hesitate out here to the right, come right from your right corner. Right there. He waited, then broke underneath the coverage, picked up blocking right there. Great block. And finally run out of bounds there by Tony Gamp, number 14. Okay. You'll see him right here. He'll come down, kind of hesitate right in here. Wait for the clear out by the linebackers, and then come in here and pick up his block. Now watch him right there. He kind of hesitates, lets a tight end drive off. Now he comes underneath it. Moeller cannot recover number 49 fast enough. Harmon gets a great block right there, number 28. And finally, Gant gets him out of bounds right there.
Era Harmon shook himself up with that block, and he has left the game. He was a little dingy, and the trainer came out. So they've had to replace him, and Bayless is back. He's one of the setbacks, along with Hudson. This is Bayless stepping outside the daylight, turning upfield inside the 20-yard line. We've got a minute left in the first half, and Pohalski wants to confer with Hayden Fry and the Iowa staff. We'll break and come back. The Hawkeyes will have two timeouts remaining. This is the final minute of the first half. Iowa ahead. Era, it's second and one, what you coaches like to call a waist down. What could happen in this situation for the Hawkeyes?
You're in perfect position to go for the bomb or the home run or a play that you think might score for you. And then if you don't get it, then you can go ahead and pick up your first down on third down because it's short. But the important thing for Pohalski, unlike what Dave Yurema did 2 or 3 weeks ago against Iowa, is to throw the ball into the defender's hands. If there's any question of doubt, throw it away.
And, of course, Rob Houtland waiting in case they cannot get the touchdown out of this impressive drive here so far late in the first half. He's going to put it up. Goes for the end zone. Intercepted. That was Eric Campbell who stepped in. He was open, and he didn't hammer it right to him.
That's exactly right, Brendan. It looked like he was going to have the touchdown, And the ball response was tremendous. From up here, it looked like he was going to get the score. They had split the seam. What a play. Here's a ground level shot here. Maholsky drops straight back and looks up the field. And here comes the ball. He was open, but the ball is up and hanging. You can see there it's wobbling a little like a duck. And right there's that play by Eric Campbell. Morrow thought he had it. He took it right out of his hands. Great play.
54 seconds to go. 10-3. Iowa leads. We've had five turnovers here in the first half. Three by Michigan. Schembechler keeps it on the ground with Jamie Morris. Out to the 28-yard line.
Let's take another look at that.
One more look here as we come right down and break to the inside, right from the upper level here. And you'll see that Maholsky, this is the thing I talked about. If there's any question of doubt, throw it away because you got all the downs ahead. Right there you see the move. Now it looks like he's open there, and that's Campbell comes in and steals that ball away. A great play.
And they continue to run it out. The crowd not pleased with the fact that Michigan is electing to run the clock out here at the end of the first half, and Hayden Fry wanting to get the clock stopped if he can. Now, while we've got a break, let's take a look at our messages from these two fine campuses. First, we'll start in Iowa City. Era Jim Harbaugh has returned after that Michigan timeout. It's first and 10, 20 seconds to go. The ball is about 70 yards away from the end zone. What would you do in this situation?
I think I'd go try to get it down the field here for nothing less than a field goal. He's got the receivers. He's deployed that way. He's going to throw it up.
Good time.
Underneath, though.
Morris. He's got the first down and gets out of bounds. 11 seconds left on that clock. That was Mike Burke, number 5, in pursuit for the Hawkeyes. That's an 11-yard gain by Morris. And
they need one more first down for field goal range because of the... They've got two great kickers, in my opinion.
Well, Gillette has already nailed the longest in the history of football here at Michigan. 53 yards this afternoon. That represents their 3 points. 11 seconds. Harbaugh drops again underneath, and White is stopped. The Hawkeyes back in that prevent, and they have the deep receivers well covered, especially Kolasar. They're extremely conscious of here. With 3 seconds to go, there's a timeout. Wolverines. Sarah?
I think with 3 seconds, well, I would do it. Pull Paul Jokic, their 6'8", 235-pound split end. Put him right down the field and let Harbaugh throw the ball and try to play a little basketball rebound. They don't have time to make a first down to get the field goal attempt.
Well, there's your man.
There he is. That's what I would do. Come on, Bull. Let's see what you do.
You two do think alike. Well, you know, Michigan gets the loudest cheer in this stadium, but the second loudest, it goes to Slippery Rock. Folks, when they announce that score at Michigan Stadium, the place explodes, and Slippery Rock winning easily today. In fact, there's so much loyalty for Slippery Rock here at Ann Arbor that in 1979, the athletic director, he brought Slippery Rock in here for a game against Shippensburg, and folks, they sold 61,000 tickets to that game.
That's a nice-sized crowd.
I think I'd bring them back every year. That's a few tickets, a little parking, hot dog sales. Not a bad day at the cash register. Second and 9 with time running out, and here's one of the key interceptions.
It really was. Not only did he save a possible touchdown, but he took away opportunities because Iowa was only in a second down and short situation.
The three receivers down the right side. Harbaugh puts it up for grabs. And a great grab by the freshman wide receiver, Craig McMurtry, with time running out. It's a 46-yard reception. It was the longest play of the half by Michigan. Came a little bit too late. So we end up the first half with one touchdown. It came on the opening drive. And it was the Hawkeyes who scored it. Bass has it, and now he doesn't. But the official says he broke the plane. Good enough for six. And it's a 10-3 halftime score. Jim Nance will be coming your way. Then we'll be back here with Pat O'Brien and Ira Parsegan when we continue after this message and a word from your local station. We're at halftime with the Iowa Hawkeyes leading the Michigan Wolverines 10-3 in our battle of the unbeatens here on CBS this afternoon. And, Ira, what about the two clubs' running games that they unleashed in the first half?
I've been impressed, particularly with the Iowa defense. They're really both on the coverage as well as the run. I didn't realize they were as strong as they are.
Well, this is what they have done against the Michigan team rushing. You can see that no one has dominated. There's quarterback Jim Harbaugh, and as far as his passing is concerned, well, it has not been that spectacular so far. 7 of 13 for 88 yards and one interception. And Ira, take us here to Ira's angle and show us this mental mistake that was made in this play.
Well, this was out of the wishbone, and Jamie Morris here at left halfback, they're going to run the bone this way, and he should be trailing for the pitch. And as you will see, he will go the opposite way. And, of course, Harbaugh doesn't realize that. He looks to throw the ball, and the ball is obviously fumbled. There's nobody there to field the ball. This was a big turnover that was very costly to the Wolverines.
Now, there were also some near misses in the game. The Wolverines might have struck for a touchdown. They used that wishbone formation, and as Arrow showed you, they really break the fullback free here, Arrow.
Both the ends are out here to carry the defenders out, and White slips through here after Harbaugh fakes the ball to him. You get a blocking here and here, but he almost gets it right down the middle. Take a look at White from the fullback spot. Cheated up, slips through, right there. And right off of his fingertips.
We've had some near misses and I think some spectacular work by the defensive backs. Watch Ken Sims here working against Greg McMurtry. Now watch him with his left hand. He strips the ball and knocks it free. That was down inside the 5-yard line, and it cost the Wolverines a scoring opportunity right there. But what about young Tom Pajolski for the Hawks?
Pajolski has had a fairly good first half, although he didn't put any points on the board with the turnovers. You see, he's 5 of 13 for 99 yards. And here was that interception on second down and short where he thought he had the touchdown. And you get a great response here by Eric Campbell, number 5.
Yeah, for some of the youngsters out there, what happens on a quarterback's release when it flutters like that? What did he do mechanically incorrectly on that?
He apparently did not have a good grip on that ball, and he may have been anxious to throw it. He saw that he was open, and he wanted to get rid of it, and he rushed it.
What about second half? What do you think we can expect?
Well, it's been a defensive game in a sense because there's been turnovers in the ball game. I've been impressed, as I mentioned. Iowa's got a great defense. I think Michigan has got to find some way to get their receivers open if they're going to get back into this ball game. Harbaugh's a great passer, but he's been forced to scramble and throw underneath, and you've got to take your hat off to this Iowa defense.
All right, so we're going to come back and find out what will happen in the second half, and we'll return after this message and a word from your local station.
Pat O'Brien on the Michigan side with Gary Mulder, the defensive coordinator. What do you have to do to get back in this game, guys?
Well, Pat, I think probably offensively I haven't been watching a whole lot of execute a little bit better and make sure that we don't have another drive like we had at opening series. I'd like to have that drive back.
Confident?
Oh, I think we can win the football game. Yeah, we know Iowa's a good team, but we're a pretty good football team, too, and I think we're going to find a fired up team when you come back.
All right, I'll let you go back to work.
Thank you, Pat.
Brent, back to you.
All right, Pat, thank you. I'll tell you one thing that Gary Mulder's defense has to shut down is first down. The Hawkeyes averaged almost 7 yards a pop on first down, and second and three makes it look pretty good for the offense. Michigan, on the other hand, has averaged only 4.7 on first down, Coach.
But Michigan in the third period has scored 41 points to their opposition's 9. They generally make good adjustments at halftime.
Now, one sign we saw that Hayden Fry may be changing quarterbacks is that the veteran Mark Vlasic, who has not played because of an injury, came out early ahead of the team and warmed up on that far sideline. No indication yet that he's going to make the change, but we'll keep an eye down there and see if Hayden might not want to try another quarterback. Vlasic was shaken up and did not play against Michigan State, and that's when Tom Pajolski emerged. Vlasic, the fifth year senior, who backed up Chuck Long all those years. And Paholsky defeated Michigan State and then hung on against Wisconsin. They had a great ball control drive late. And here it's 10-3. Iowa leading, and Murphy will kick it off, and Jim Harbaugh and the Wolverines will be at bat first. That low kick picked up by Holloway, pounded out of bounds there near the 25-yard line. J.J. Puck, number 32. Now tomorrow, 12:30 Eastern Time, the NFL Today, I Spy, how teams cooperate against their competitors. We'll have that story tomorrow at our halftime of our games, and Joe Theismann will be with us live tomorrow. He's going to take a look at quarterback injuries around the league and our key games coming up, Dallas against Philadelphia. That's our early big game, and then late the big ones, the Giants, Seattle. 12:30 Eastern Time on CBS with the NFL Today. Irv Cross and Jimmy the Greek will be there too. So here we go. First and 10, and Michigan trailing. Harbaugh running Morris on first down, and Jamie gets to the 33-yard line. Rick Schmidt, number 11, tackled him there. Short of a first down, but it'll be second and short.
Well, it got to the outside. They faked the play to the off-tackle play, and Jamie's got the kind of speed to turn the corner, and he did. It's one of the few times they've been able to get to the outside. The halftime statistics are a little bit misleading because of the big play to McMurtry on the last play of the first half.
Number 77, Myron Kepi, has played well defensively for Iowa. Came in as a replacement for Tim Anderson. They open the hole. They trap right there in that spot, and they break Morris out past the 40. Here, take a look at this sequence as they get Kepi moving.
You'll see they fake the ball to the field, then he comes back. Now White, number 22, comes through and makes a good block right there on number 46, Dan Wirth.
Very well executed play by the Wolverines. Ball's at the 41. They run White, stays on his feet. He's across midfield, running hard for the first down. And Bruce Gear, 94, and Powell Crow, 18 defensively, wrap him up. And I think Schimbeckler said, let's get the helmets down and do a little work here in the second half.
Got a little help from the offensive line, too, from Mike Husar at left tackle. He comes right in there and makes a great block. You see White pick that daylight right there. That's vintage Schimbeckler football, isn't it? Run the ball.
Kolasar's in motion. It's Morris. And Kepi penetrated first. He is down at the 49-yard line. He stepped around him, and Joe Mott, 97, peeled over to his left.
Mott did a good job there containing him. Springing it out a long way.
We've got a penalty being assessed against the Wolverines. So another mistake here by the Michigan offense. They have turned the ball over three times in the first half of this game, and several penalties against them, Era.
Right in the same spot, too. Most of them occurred right here. The two fumbles occurred right around midfield. Offense. Holding.
So they'll mark off the yardage. Referee here this afternoon is Tom Quinn. Tom Manning's the umpire. Jim Keogh's the head linesman. Tom Hoffman, the line judge. Michael Sheehan's the field judge. Tom Bryan, the side judge. And the back judge, Bill Carollo. It is first and 20 for Harbaugh and the Wolverines. Higgins and Kolasar are the wide men. Time, and he comes up over the middle to Morris. Morris breaks free inside the 45. Finally, Dan Wirth got him down, but it's a 17-yard gain. It'll leave them short of the first down. Remember, that was a first and 20, but Morris broke that tackle.
And a nice block by Jeff Brown, to shake Jamie loose. Jamie fakes the off the tailback play. There's the ball by Harbaugh. Now watch Brown come back and pick up Sims right there and adds the extra yardage to that play.
Unusual for George Davis not to wrap someone up in that situation. Morris, four catches for 44 yards. White is in front of him in the eye as the fullback. And he'll carry on first down to the 39-yard line. Let's see where they spot that ball. Dave Haight was there on this second down. It was a second and a long three to go for the first down.
Haight did a nice job of coming off the block by Vitale.
Believe they're going to have to measure this, Coach. Let's see. Now they're going to bring the sticks out. Opening moments of the second half, along with Eric Horsig, and I'm Brent Musburger. Iowa leading Michigan 10-3.
Yep.
And a first down for the Wolverines.
Well, it made up that 20 yards in two plays.
Ball is at the Hawkeye 39-yard line. Capacity crowd here at Michigan Stadium. That familiar Wolverine helmet. Quarterback Jim Harbaugh eyeing the defense. Morris nowhere. And Dave Haight, 64 and 94, Bruce Geer broke across that line of scrimmage. This Hawkeye defense has had tremendous penetration here this afternoon when they've needed it.
Haight in particular, again, he came across. He was in the secondary there, avoided his block, and made the play.
It's second and 11 for the Wolverines. Kolasar and Higgins are both out to Harbaugh's left. To White, and he is down at the 30-yard line with Rick Schmidt, number 11, bringing him down defensively. They cleared it out with the two wide men and sent him in underneath for a 10-yard gain.
Made a good fake in there to bring him out of there. Harbaugh had him wide open in the left flat.
This will be a third and one in an era you would expect Michigan to power ahead and get the first down in this situation.
Well, they like to go to the bone here. There they are with two tight ends.
Perriman straight ahead right into the middle, and number 37 George Davis was there to meet him at the point of attack.
Looks pretty close, Brent.
Hayden Fry had Larry Station at that spot, but the Wolverines pick it up as a result of this line surge. Here, let's take a look at it.
Well, the good offensive line movement in there. You've got Dames, Hammerstein, number 78. Oh, he's got his right arm on him in there.
That
got
helps.
Away with one there.
Ball is at the 28. This is the ninth play coming, and the Wolverines have controlled it for 4.5 minutes to start the third quarter. And again, just pounding Perriman right behind center John Vitale against Hayden Fry's defensive middle, Dave Haight, the nose guard. And he's been busy on the last few plays. Perriman got down to the 26-yard line. And against Motton and company, it'll be second and 7 for Harbaugh and the Wolverines. This reminds you of Michigan teams of old, doesn't it? Helmet to helmet, they want to go on this drive.
And the bone again with two splits.
Different fullback this time is White.
There he is in the middle. There it is, right there.
They use him as a receiver. Touchdown, Michigan.
first half that that play was there. Michigan using the swinging gate on the extra point. It was a 25-yard touchdown by White on the pass from Harbaugh. And here's Moons for the extra point. Ball is on its way, and we are deadlocked.
Well, this was the play that misfired in the first half that Harbaugh overthrew slightly. They came back with the same play. This time it was wide open. You'll see it. You'll see right here, White will go right through the line right there. And both ends turn out to take away the defenders, and you see White wide open in the seats. Number 11, Schmidt, misses the tackle there, and White pulls it into the end zone. And this is a 10-10 ball game.
Now the Wolverines move into a 10-all tie. 9:35 in the third. We'll be right back. CBS Sports presents College Football, sponsored by the people of Rockwell International, where science gets down to business. Your Toyota dealer and the all-new affordable Tercel. Who could ask for anything more? And by Valvoline Motor Oil, where motor oil is not just motor oil. Let's take a look at the Gerald White touchdown from the end zone. The senior from Titusville, Florida. Era, they'd used Perriman at that spot. Now they put White in there.
They came right through here and down through the seam. And Harbaugh fakes the bone, fakes to him, to White. There it is. And throws it right down the middle. Now Schmidt has a crack at him. There's 22 coming down the sweep. You'll see Rich Schmidt come right in here from the left and miss the tackle right there. And White pulls his way right into the end zone for the score. That's Crowe, number 18, the free safety trying to stop him, but that's a mismatch there.
An impressive 5.5-minute drive, 75 yards, 10 plays. Jim Harbaugh was 3 of 3 for 52 yards. That was his best sequence of the game. And White taking it in for the touchdown, and it's 10-all, 9:35. And Mike Gillette to kick it off for Schembechler. Kevin Harmon looking for an alley. Smack there, 26-yard line. Well, a reminder that tomorrow we'll start our NFL coverage at 12:30 Eastern Time with the NFL Today. It's a doubleheader Sunday, and a big one, the Giants and the Seahawks. And the Hawkeyes go back to work, and this is their first offensive series, and Tom Pahulski remains at quarterback. High formation. The crowd into it. Bayless. Andre McIntyre, big number 54. Era, he's coming alive a little bit here this afternoon.
They expected big things from him, and they weren't exactly happy with his performance up to date. They knew that one time or another he would get the job done. He certainly is in this ball game. Andre McIntyre, 6'1", 241 from Chicago. Great speed, an outstanding athlete, and a fine young man.
Second and 10. Incomplete and almost intercepted. That was David Arnold, number 15, the corner on that side.
And he had Bobby Smith wide open on the play. It was the play that they had hit in the first half, that Bobby Smith came all the way across the field. But that time, Pahulski just overthrew him. You'll see Bobby Smith come into your frame on the left corner right there, but you see he's wide open. The ball is way overthrown. Arnold, number 15, almost comes back to get it.
Shift Morrow out to the right wing. Overthrew Smith. And Pahulski is having a rough time right now. He is 2 of his last 9. And Mark Vlasic gets back up and starts loosening up again for the Hawkeyes on the far sideline.
Well, Brenny, he had Smith open on both of those plays. not necessarily big gainers, but they had a chance with Smith with his hands on the ball of picking up a first down. And those were misfires.
Oscar Bollard gets one up in the air under pressure. Kolasar battles his way back to the 35-yard line. That's a 45-yard punt and a 6-yard return. We'll come back. Our score is tied. I think Pat O'Brien has found a new host for the CBS Morning News. Here's Millie Schembechler with Pat. Take it away.
That's right, Brent. I asked her about it. She said we couldn't afford her. Millie, thanks for joining us. What is Bo Schembechler like on a big game week?
It depends on how the game, how the team practices. If they have a good practice, he's wonderful. If they're not practicing well, if their attitude's bad, he's terrible.
How much do you get involved in all this?
Too much emotionally. You know, I'm really removed from the action and from the field and from the team itself. But
when would you like Bo back? When do you want him out of this pressure cooker?
Well, I hope we're around in a couple of years, and I'm looking forward to that. But I tell you, I can't get a commitment out of him.
All right, thanks for joining us, Millie. Behind every great man is a great woman. Let's go back to Brent.
You got that right. First and 10. Thanks, Pat. On the rolls, Harbaugh. Zips one to the sideline, and Kolasar with his first reception of the day. And now Bo starts to open it up a little bit. Ken Sims on the coverage, 12-yard gain, Era.
And good protection, and Kolasar ran a beautiful route. Came up the field, then he came back for the football like all good receivers should. Not wait for the ball to be intercepted. Here he makes a great fake to the inside, waits. Now he delivers. You'll see Kolasar come back for the ball so that Sims cannot jump in for the interception. Excellent route.
And a first down for the Wolverines. They're tied with the Hawkeyes. Ball is on their own 46. Jamie Morris is wrapped up that time. That's good play there by Dave Haight. That nose guard, he really coming at him again.
Well, he's given that Vitale, number 67, the Michigan center, a bad time, particularly in this second half. You see there, he's 6'3", 260.
Good football family, that one. Already sent one son into the NFL, a first-round draft choice. Got another one on his way.
I thought they'd have a tough time replacing Hap Peterson of a year ago.
Exactly.
But Haight's doing quite a job.
Here's second and 11. We've got 7:50 to go in the third. Here's the wishbone. And White is back at that fullback spot with Perriman at halfback. They're going to throw out of it. Under pressure, what a lick he took. It's along to Kolasar. Incomplete. And Harbaugh was hammered at the other end. John Breeze got in on him and delivered the blow. But Harbaugh's got a beautiful pass off. And down on the coverage was number 44, Keaton Smiley.
I don't know whether Keaton got his hand in there or not, or whether or not he could have caught this ball. Let's take another look here from the end zone. Does Keaton get his arm in there? At least it's a distracting arm. Normally, Kolasar just gobbles those balls up. Now, let's take another closer look at this. Let's see whether or not Keaton gets his hands on it. It looked like he just tagged it because Kolasar is a great concentrating receiver.
Well, here is the pressure, and Breeze, 57, coming in, delivers that blow, and that was almost a foul when you come up in that helmet area like that. Boy, did he take him down. Harbaugh bounces right back up. It's third and 11 for the Wolverines.
Blitz.
Gets it off to Higgins, and Higgins slipped, or he might have gone all the way.
Great read by Harbaugh on the blitz. Got rid of that ball to Higgins. Higgins was wide open. Watch the blitz come. You see Davis blitzing right through the seam right there. He's picked up. Now right there is Higgins wide open. And he slips and falls here. Otherwise, he could have gone, as Brent pointed out, a long gainer.
Yeah, because he had the defensive back committed on that carpet, and it was going to be very difficult for him. And Harbaugh says, oh, he went down. I could have had six more. But it's a 15-yard gain, and that's the seventh first down for Michigan this half. Good adjustments by the Wolverine coaching staff now. And coming back, Jamie Morris sort of squirts through that. Oh, look at him crawling. He comes free, and he's crawling down there inside the 30-yard line.
I don't know where he found any daylight in there that time, Brent. Didn't look like there was anything. He waited, was patient, and must have gotten a little seam in there that he grabbed.
Hayden's big guys are saying, where'd he go? What happened to him? He was here a second ago.
That's right. I thought it was going to be a negative play.
Second and three. Oh, Harbaugh brings the Wolverines up. The ball is down to the Iowa 32. Morris, not this time. I mean, Brad Quast, number 35, that freshman linebacker out of Des Plaines, Illinois, came in there and applied the clincher. Here's a shot of Jamie Morris. You get an idea of the size. I mean, Joe Morris, you've seen him run in the NFL, and Jamie is even smaller than he is. And look at him. Where is he? You know, you can't see him when you're in behind those big galoots. And now, folks, he's crawling free from the other end. 6:15 to go. Michigan 10, Iowa 10. Thomas Wilshire, number 27, checks in at tailback. Morris gets a breather. And here's Wilshire.
What a big hole that time over the left side. Great blocking by the offensive line. From the end zone, we'll take another look at this. It'll be over your right side as you look at it as a viewer. Oh, great job by the left guard, Dames. Excellent job. Drove him clear off the line. That was Haight. That was a big hole. Well blocked by the Wolverines.
From the wishbone, they run Wilshire back to the other side, and he gets a first down almost to the 15-yard line.
They've got momentum right now. That the Michigan ball club, and they're keeping the...
How did they seize command of this game here for Coach Shimbeko in the second half? Why are they so much more impressive against Hayden Fry's defense?
Well, it seems they must have been motivated at halftime by Bo. You've got to certainly give credit to that.
I think he threw a couple chairs in there or something.
But they did, as I said, they make good adjustments at halftime.
They run the short man, the fullback, White. And they're battling for extra yards against Hayden's defense harder than they did in the first half.
No team, and this is the sixth game for Iowa, has ever scored a touchdown on the ground. So let's see whether or not Bo elects to try to muscle it in or whether or not he's going to use Harbaugh. He's got second down about four.
You think Bo is aware of that stat? You think he'd like to get one on Hayden? Now, Hayden's beat him twice in a row. Has anybody ever beaten him three times?
No one's ever beaten Bo three times in a row.
Woody Hayes never did it?
Nope. Not consecutively.
And here's the second and four. Here's White. Running hard. He's got it. The extra point. The Wolverines fight back.
Okay, from the end zone, you'll see the crossbuck. He fakes for the fullback, and look at that hole through there. An excellent power running. Look at him reach for that end zone. And the first touchdown on the ground against Iowa this year.
And on the far side, Mark Vlasic snaps on a chin strap. We'll be right back.
This Heisman Trophy moment is brought to you by Kodak. In 1973, John Cappelletti accepted the Heisman, but not for himself. Walter Cronkite shared the story with America.
Last night in New York, Cappelletti was presented the award by Vice President Gerald Ford. But Cappelletti said he thought it ought to go to someone else.
The youngest member of my family, Joseph, is very ill. He has leukemia. And if I could dedicate this trophy to him tonight and give him a couple days of happiness, this is worth everything.
Introducing Kodacolor VRG film.
We're all moving to a different rhythm. Our hearts are beating to a different drum. That's what
keeps the whole world spinning.
And that's what makes the whole world fun. Don't you know we're all part of the color of life?
The most accurate, realistic color in print film is here. New Kodacolor VRG.
The color of life.
Take a look at the blocking on this play. Dame's the guard, blocks right there. Hussar right there. And you get Wilshire going right through, a fake to the fullback and the hand back, and he goes for the score. Watch it. Good blocking by the left guard, left tackle. Now you see Wilshire, number 27, go three through, pick up Smiley. Missed tackler by Bruce Geer, but White was not going to be denied.
Mark Vlasic ready to step in here. Michigan with 151 yards this half, and Iowa with none. Tom Pajolski wearing the headset, and Hayden Fry will turn over the quarterbacking to the senior from Monaca, Pennsylvania, with Michigan ahead for the first time, 17-10. Gillette will kick it off. Robert Smith and Harmon back deep for the Hawkeyes. 4 minutes to go here in the third quarter. Short of the 20-yard line. It's a fired-up Michigan team right now. Well, next Saturday, CBS Sports begins its exclusive coverage of the NBA with Quest for the Crown. That's a preview of the NBA's 41st season. Dick Stockton and Tom Heitz will take a look at the teams and players along with Pat O'Brien. So an NBA preview next Saturday at 3 Eastern on CBS Sports. Here it is, first and 10 for the Hawkeyes at the 4-minute mark. And Mark Vlasic, his first series. And he uses Bayless on a cutback. Bayless gets out to the 24-yard line.
Interesting to see the first time that Mark Vlasic tries to throw the ball, whether or not he has the power because of that shoulder injury, a shoulder separation. Pajolski looking on.
Time remaining in the third. Split backs for Vlasic. Inside shovel to Bayless. Bayless breaks free for the first down. Gets out beyond the 35-yard line. And Hicks, number 17, tackled him after a 13-yard run by Bayless, that little inside shovel pass. We see that at least once a game, or every time we go out now.
And it seems to work almost every time that we see it. The line is rushing the passer. You'll watch right here. Bayless at the left halfback spot. Sneaks underneath. There's a little deal right there. And you see the big hole in there because everyone's coming after what they think is going to be the passer.
Vlasic changing the call at the line. Hands off to Bayless, who breaks a tackle. Got to the 42-yard line. That was Harris, the nose guard, 56, who came across. And then Bayless twisted free of him.
But Bayless gives you everything, doesn't he?
Well, he really does.
That second effort.
Watching from the sidelines, White and Wilshire, two of the talented running backs for this Michigan team. Bayless runs with the determination of a fullback.
You know, Alex Agassi, the former coach at Northwestern and certainly at Purdue and three-time All-American and also on the staff, told me that Michigan probably does as good a job of adjusting at halftime as anyone he's ever seen. This is going to be a quick out.
Well, Vlasic taking the delay, and there was a penalty flag down on the call. We see one difference with the senior out here right away for the Hawkeyes, and that's the fact that he is audibly more at the line of scrimmage.
We haven't seen him throw that ball yet, Brent. But I'm anxious to see what kind of strength he has in his arm. It's been just a little shovel pass, and it looked like he wanted to throw on that play.
Well, Andy Moeller is off the field defensively for the Wolverines, and J.J. Grant, the sophomore, replaces him. Moeller apparently suffered a slight cut
up above the right eye. Does not appear to be serious. But that's why McIntyre, number 54, is calling the play down there defensively against Vlasic. This is second and 11. There's his first pass, throw it on the button to Bayless. Bayless steps out to the 46, and it's going to be close to a first down.
Just slipped right out of that left halfback spot. Wide receivers drove the defenders back off. Bayless slipped into that flat. Good call. You can see him audibilize. You can see that he had the flat over here. Watch Bayless slip right out here, right in your picture, right at you.
They'll bring the sticks from the far side of the field for the measurement. That was Grant who came over there on the coverage, but Era, they would miss Moeller if he's out very long.
Yes, because he calls all the defensive signals and the checks for the line. And of course, you know, the coach's son, he knows probably as much about the game plan as anybody. Just short.
Moeller is standing with his helmet off behind his teammates, just to the left of the 50-yard line. Number 49, their outstanding linebacker, with a minute 51, is on the sideline because of an injury. A couple of the medical folks are speaking to him briefly down there. This is a third and short. Vlasic brings up that power eye formation. Hudson and Bayless, and this is Hudson. He broke free of McIntyre, bounced off of him, and got the first down inside the 50-yard line. McIntyre should have wrapped him up in the line of scrimmage, Earl.
That's two tough hombres there, Hudson and McIntyre. That battle was won by Hudson.
Waxahachie, Texas defeated Chicago, Illinois.
Yeah, that's right.
Now McIntyre's got an added burden. He's not accustomed to this. Taking the calls from the sideline, switching it in. Now that defense was a little bit confused on this.
Right, see, that's where it hurts.
Real big trouble out there.
Really confused.
With Moeller on that sideline right now. Vlasic backs up further and will not break free. John Willingham, number 39, did a fine job defensively.
Better throw that same confused defense in again. I mean, now that's the one you need. Talk about, you know, falling into things. Look like they could be in real trouble, and they wind up with a sack.
A 12-yard loss on that sack. Well, you know, Coach, you know what he said? When in doubt, rush.
And there's Willingham right there coming off of his block and dumping Vlasic for a 12-yard loss.
Who is that? Wester, 73, the tackle on that side. He couldn't hold him out forever. Inside of a minute. Second and a bunch. And they come right back up the middle. Hokertzma wraps up the ball carrier. And that was Bayless. This will be a third and 16 for Hayden Fry's offense. He sends in Marv Cook, the tight end, with the play, Era.
And Hayden was there checking his checklist on long yardage situations. You have a short and a long yardage situation. We've already planned it out, so there's no hesitation about the call.
Classic. Over the middle, complete to Smith. And Smith is inside the 30-yard line with the first down on a third and 16. He gets 25 yards.
And that's why I wanted to see whether or not Vlasic could throw the ball, and he demonstrated right there that he can hum it. Smith will come right down the field and break across the middle. He's the outside man here. Now watch him break in. Vlasic throws a strike in there, and that ball's got some power on it. His shoulder is okay.
He was in a beautiful spot against that defense. In behind McIntyre, and here is the throwing motion of the quarterback who's coming back from the injured shoulder.
This is the first long pass he's thrown where he has to put a little zip on it. There it is, right there. Fine.
The end of the third quarter, and we'll be right back after this message and a word from your local stations.
CBS Sports presents College Football.
sponsored by your Toyota dealer and the all-new sporty Corolla FX16. Who could ask for anything more? The Equitable, your key to financial opportunity. And by AC Delco, the smart parts. It will be tough going for this Michigan defense without their field leader. Number 49, Andy Moeller, is like having an assistant coach on the field, relaying the signals and leading this team defensively. And Iowa has put together a drive right now. Vlasic is 3 of 3 since coming off the bench for 49 yards. They pound back inside with the fullback out of that formation. J.J. Grant, number 95. He's the linebacker who came off the bench to replace Moeller. He wrapped up Hudson that time. And the ball is down at the 26-yard line. And, it's going to be very difficult for this defense to hold together mentally without Moeller.
Well, I was watching as Moeller was on the sideline there. The trainer was to his left, and the doctor was talking to him directly. And I don't know, he might have a mild concussion of some sort. But they're not going to let him back in here until he's absolutely perfect, or they think that he is.
Second down and 7. And Vlasic conferring with the referee. He'll take them back into the huddle. He has Robert Smith. Aaron, you have noticed in the pass patterns, what about Smith so far today for the Hawkeyes?
Smith has been open. If you recall, Poholski overthrew him on 2 occasions where they had opportunities to pick up first downs, and he is really a dangerous receiver. He can really fly. As I said earlier, that he's their big play flanker, and he caught that pass to make this drive continue on the long yardage situation.
He's averaging 23 yards a catch on 2 catches. And again, Vlasic checks out at the line of scrimmage with the clock running down. Now from the I formation, they will run Bayless to the short side, and he is out of room. Now, we've got to find out about Moeller, so let's go down to the field and Pat O'Brien. Pat?
In fact, Brent, Andy Moeller is probably the most watched person in this game right now. The athletic medicine department here telling me that he got hit very hard in the head, and he's very lightheaded. It's not a mild concussion, but he's very, very lightheaded. They're going to keep their eye on him now, and they hope to get him back in soon. But soon won't be soon enough, I think. Let's go back upstairs.
All right, Pat, thank you. 2 good defensive plays in a row here, although the audible right into the coverage of the defense that time.
He did. Came to the short side of the field. He misread it. But this is where they've been dangerous. They've had open receivers. 3rd down. And they're going to go to the air with a double wing, very likely.
They ran Hudson. They slipped him, and he got inside the 20-yard line. And let's see where they spot that ball. The first down marker was between the 18 and the 19, closer to the 19. Andre McIntyre, 54, was trying to get a saddle on him. And hog time, but that Hudson runs tough. They're going to call time and measure it. That's how close it is here.
But it was a good call. They deployed to a double wing. Looked like a passing down situation. Michigan deployed out to the outside, and the next thing you know, they slip the ball inside and pick up the first down or close to it.
That's short. And from short. Michigan Stadium, the drama here this afternoon has unfolded this way. In the opening minutes of this game, the Hawkeyes took the kickoff and moved in with Bass scoring from a yard out. It was 7-0. Then after that, the Wolverines kicked a record breaker for the school. Gillette's 53-yarder, it was 7-3. But Houtland added a 29-yarder to make it 10-3. And in the 3rd quarter, Michigan dominated. Harbaugh to White, and then the first rushing touchdown against the Hawkeye defense this year, and Michigan leading 17-10. This is 4th and short from the power. Bass in motion. Bayless. Slipped up, and Billy Harris, the nose man, number 56, got inside on him, and let's see where they spot it, whether or not they gave him enough for the first down. It looks like he did not get it. Michigan celebrating. However, the referee still wants to measure this. Hold on just a second. Boy, that nose man got in there.
Billy Harris, I can't believe how much penetration he got on the play. And no, they had no chance on it.
What a play by Billy Harris against Hayden Fry's Hawkeyes. The biggest play of the game was a defensive play by the nose man.
Number 56. Look at the penetration he gets right there and makes the play. is lined up over the left guard, the right side of the screen.
Iowa may have outsmarted itself. David Hudson normally is the man who gets the call in that situation. They looked elsewhere. We'll be back.
We're not a company.
But we recognize potential. We develop it. We use it.
We'll make sure that as your responsibility grows, so will you.
As your ability for leadership grows, so will you.
Working with us, you'll gain self-confidence.
Become a person with a future.
We're not a company.
We're your country.
We're the Marines.
The Army.
The Navy.
The Air Force.
We're the armed forces.
It's a great place to start.
Balance. It is stability based on planned diversity. Rockwell International's continuous growth results from a balance of businesses. Outstanding performance in electronics, aerospace, automotive, industrial automation, and general industries. Rockwell International, down-to-earth management and opportunities as limitless as space.
How did he angle his way in?
Billy Harris right here, 6'1", 270, is lined up right over the guard. He loops into that seam and gets that kind of penetration and makes the tackle right there. Great defensive play. Let's look at it. You'll see him move to his right. Defeat the blocker, get all kinds of penetration right there, and Bayless is knocked down, does not have a chance to pick up the first down.
Senior out of the state of Ohio. Does the job for Bo Schembechler's defense. They were under enormous heat, but they are not home free yet. They need a ball control drive here at the 13:31 mark. Iowa used 12 plays, 5:37, and came up empty-handed. They run the fullback straight ahead on first down. That was Gerald White. Let's go to Jim Nance in New York for an update. Jim.
All right, Brent, that key game between Arizona State and USC. The Sun Devils kicked the field goal to tie it. Then they caught the Trojans napping on the ensuing kickoff. Robbie Boyd with the recovery. The very next play, Jeff Van Raphorst goes long, and there's Aaron Cox. 34-yard score makes it 13-6. Let's go back to Brent and Aaron.
All right, Jim, Van Raphorst. As he goes, so goes the Sun Devils. Harbaugh going long for Kolesar. Overthrow him.
Going for the home run on second down. See him right here. Kolesar just comes right up the field. Goes by Sims. Sims has actually got the flat. You see number 18, Crow, comes over for the coverage, but the ball is overthrown. Crow would have been there to play it.
This is third and eight for the Wolverines. Extra defensive back on the field for the Hawkeyes. White and Morris are the running backs.
I like Jokic over the middle on this play. There it is.
Overthrow, intercepted by the Hawkeyes. And that is Sistrunk, the nickel man who's come in the game. Gets it inside the 20-yard line. A huge turnover. That's the fourth turnover by Michigan in this game. Iowa has not scored off one yet, but what an opportunity.
See, Jokic will come in from your left side. They like this. You see, it seems going to be open, but he overthrows Higgins there. I thought he was trying to go to Jokic. And, of course, you see Sistrunk with the interception. Big play for the Hawkeyes. See, Jokic right here comes down and breaks in. Higgins comes underneath him, and he's open right there, but Harbaugh overthrows him. Let's roll it and take a look at it. Jokic at 6'8", breaks deeper. There's Higgins right over the middle right there. Over his hands, into the hands of Sistrunk right there. Big play.
And now defensively for the Wolverines, Andy Moeller trots back onto the field. He has returned. Vlasic and the Hawkeyes with a first down. They run the delay, and Bayless breaks free and gets down near the 16-yard line. Messner, number 60, was the first to get at it.
Boy, Hayden's hot about something there.
You know what he just said, folks? He just said those audibles are going to kill us. That's exactly what he said.
I heard the
and I'll tell you, he audibled into the heart of the defense over here on that last series, and I wasn't sure what was happening. Here's Bayless. He's stacked up at the 15. Andy Moeller, 49, gets in there.
Looks like he's all right. There's Moeller right there, number 49, right at a ground level shot. There's the ball to Bayless, and here comes Moeller right in there on the play. Great defensive play. It's a big down right here, third down and about, what, six there.
At the 11:30 mark, Michigan leading Iowa 17-10. Hawkeyes with a chance to tie it or get close. Vlasic straight back. In the end zone, and Smith, who's got it. Touchdown, Iowa. A 15-yard touchdown pass from Vlasic to Smith. Boy, we got one brewing here this afternoon, Era.
Vlasic was really cool on the play. Was finally flushed out of the pocket to his right. Smith came all the way across deep in the end zone. He was wide open. Vlasic picked him up and did a nice job. Boy, that's a great job there.
Chuck Hartley will hold for Houtland. All. 11 minutes and 15 seconds. That's what's left here in Ann Arbor, Michigan. The Iowa Hawkeyes.
Excuse me, Brent. This is where he comes from, way over here, and comes all the way down and breaks all the way into that corner. Vlasic comes out here when he's flushed. Let's take a look. You see Smith up at the top. He comes down the field. Now he starts to work his way all the way across the end zone. Keeps moving with Vlasic. And there's the throw right there and the touchdown.
The young wide receiver from Dallas, Texas, makes a superb catch in the end zone. As the senior comes off the bench and gets the job done on this play, but thanks to a great effort by number two Smith at the other end. And Smith has caught three passes for 60 yards here this afternoon. 11:15 to go. Michigan and Iowa are tied at 17, just what you'd expect. Well, let's take a moment to present this week's Toyota Leadership Award to the players who've been singled out by their coaching and faculty staff for outstanding performance in the areas of the team and academics. And today's game team leadership winners are Lyle Crow from Iowa, senior finance major, a 3.1 grade point average, and Jim Harbaugh from Michigan, a senior communications major with a 3-point grade point average. And Toyota will donate a check in the amount of $1,000 to each of the school's general scholarship funds. So Hayden Fry finally gets it done. I don't think there was any audible on that call either, Coach.
that was a good job of scrambling by Vlasic and a great ability of Bobby Smith to find an open seam.
Now the kicking game. Can Michigan get field position or will Iowa get down the field behind Murphy? Murphy features those low bouncing kicks that are so difficult to field and sometimes even result in turnovers. We had one a couple weeks ago at Michigan State. The Spartans couldn't handle it.
And they kick to the corner. They'll kick it to this third of the one third or the other third of the hash marks and squeeze you down. See, they kick it over to this side here and then they'll squeeze you down.
All the way being squeezed at the 20-yard line. Well, tonight on the CBS television network, you can watch Downtown, which is a new series, or The New Mike Hammer, and The Twilight Zone, an all-new show tonight. I'm sure that no one will want to watch the World Series on that other network. No, come on. Here's a look at our scoring drive. Oh, I'm in trouble for that, I'm sure. Three plays, 19 yards, 129. Vlasic hits Smith with a touchdown pass. So 11-11 here. Remaining tied at 17. Harbaugh on the keeper coming around the left side. And he gets out to the 34-yard line for the first down. There's Kyle Crow, number 18. Just presented Kyle with that Toyota Award. He comes up with a play for us on clear.
You see, the touchdown pass that they hit to the fullback down the middle does not allow for the safety men to come up and support, and the quarterback comes free on that. Had they gone for the quarterback, the outside man, he'd have dealt the ball off. But that's what a play will do. You know, the touchdown that they hit to White, that quieted down that safety man support.
Look at that. Three of the last five games. One of them certainly was the game we broadcast last year. Houtman won it with time running out. From the wishbone, Harriman pounds right straight ahead here on first down. What kind of a drive is Schimbechler trying to put together at this moment of the game, Arrow, with 10:37 to go and the score tied?
Well, I think he's going to try to run the football, but what he probably is a little concerned about is Harbaugh's throw to Higgins on that pass that was intercepted. So you wonder whether or not he's going to want to throw it, put it up again. But I think he's going to have to against this defense. I don't think he can consistently run against them, although he's come out in the bone three times in a row now.
Second and nine for Harbaugh and the Wolverines.
They're going to put it up. Good away.
Throwing it out of bounds over Morris's head, and there was coverage over here. You know, Hayden Fry has wound up with some good athletes against this Michigan offense in that secondary. Smiley and Crow and those fellas, they play good ball back there for young men who have not had a lot of experience. Hayden Fry have been breaking them in slowly here this season.
Their coverage has been excellent. The drive actually that Michigan State took down the field was a running drive on the first score in the third quarter, and then they did hit that one big pass down the slot. A perfect call against the defense that Iowa happened to be in.
Harbaugh 12 of 22 for 167, and that touchdown pass you referred to. It's Higgins for the first time. Higgins a first down. The 48-yard line, a 13-yard gain. Harbaugh to Higgins.
Well, it was a big play to maintain possession of the ball from the end zone. You'll see Harbaugh stay in the pocket, drop right straight back, which they don't normally do. They don't like to do this. Now he leads right there. Good throw to Higgins. Higgins has got super hands. He just doesn't drop the ball.
Inside of 10 minutes remaining. We're tied at 17, Iowa and Michigan. Thomas Wilcher checks in at tailback. He's working with White and Perriman in that ball. How's that wishbone look that Bo Schembechler has used a lot here today? There's the pitch, and it's Wilcher who just come in the game. Out of bounds, Kerry Burt, the safety.
Harbaugh
took a penalty flag coming down.
Brent Harbaugh took a real shot on that. The referee was looking him over. He's up now. I guess he's all right.
And I saw a penalty flag come down on that far side. And it may be unnecessary roughness or personal foul against the Hawkeyes.
Perriman's pointing towards the Hawkeyes, personal foul, and it is.
You know, I saw Keaton Smiley working over there defensively. Let's see what happens here at the end of this play.
Number 44 right there. Oh, my, he's way out of. Look where he is, almost into the bench. He is into the bench.
There's the flag right behind us.
And that ball is down inside the 30.
Don't run the red light with the cops sitting at the intersection, right? Here's that hit you were talking about, Arrow.
Right, and the referee thought he was injured. Let's see what he deals the ball off right there.
Now, that, of course, is what you expose your quarterback to out of the wishbone.
Exactly.
He's very vulnerable. That's why you don't see it in the NFL, in case you're wondering why.
That's the risk you take.
Here's Morris down near the 25-yard line, and let's check back in with Jim Nance for an update. Jimmy, what do you got?
Well, Brent, after that Arizona State touchdown, USC marched right back. Leroy Holt with the final jolt, capping a 12-play, 76-yard drive. They're tied with seconds remaining in the first half, Brent.
Well, you got an opportunity to check in on USC next week. They'll be taking on Stanford. That's our big game here on CBS at 3:30 Eastern time. Some of the rest of you in the East will be looking at Clemson and North Carolina State. Here, in the battle of the unbeatens, the Wolverines with the ball down at the 25-yard line. Straight back, and Harbaugh will run. No, he throws it. He saw the open man was Jokic. Beautiful pass. Hammered at the 5-yard line. That was a great play by Harbaugh.
You see, Harbaugh has a presence of mind. He's going to run with the ball, but he still looks up the field. Great job. That's why he's such a great quarterback. Jokic is up on top and comes down, and you'll see Harbaugh does not find anybody open initially. And he'll fake the wishbone to the left. Now he turns. White is out to the left flat. He sees daylight. Now the response right there. That's a great quarterback that does that. That is very impressive.
A 21-yard gain. And the Wolverines come to the 5-yard line with a first and goal. And they come through with White. Gets down to the 3 and perhaps the 2-yard line before he was shoved back to Burke.
They're just running power football from the ground level here. You see him come over the right side of your good block in there. White finds the daylight right there. And finally is stood up. There's Burke, number 3, makes the initial hit, who is the free strong safety. Look at about 2.5 to 3 yards there to go.
White is the right halfback. And they pound straight ahead for Perriman, and the Hawkeyes were ready that time defensively. George Davis, Myron Kepi, 37-77. Dave hates the note. The wheels turning on both sidelines, Era.
You're hitting, say, watch the counter play. Bo, he's already got what he wants in.
Ball is at the 2-yard line on this third and goal.
Look out.
Harbaugh keeps it. Sims comes in. Gets him at the 10-yard line.
Boy, that Sims been a big play man, hasn't he?
No more Mr. Nice Guy.
They've got a corner blitz on from the far side of the screen. Sims comes clean. Harbaugh's looking for a receiver. Does not send Sims on his back. And, of course, he's sacked back there. They're forced to a field goal situation.
And it will be Moons attempting the 27-yarder. No good. It was off to the kicker's right.
Great goal line stand, Brent, by the Hawkeyes.
What a play by Sims down there, Era.
Really was. They brought the corner blitz.
There's 6 minutes and 10 seconds to go in this game. Moons thought he kicked it through, realized it there at the end when he saw the signal. Meanwhile, the other side. Iowa and Michigan still tied. We'll be back for the last 6-10.
Is this Howard Johnson?
Yes, sir. There's been a lot of changes. You might say we're turning the place upside down.
You know, a lot is changing at Howard Johnson. New rooms, new furnishings, and new attention to service.
It's different. I like it.
1 second. I'm just straightening up.
No matter how you look at it,
this is Howard Johnson.
We're turning Howard Johnson upside down. Manage. To handle or direct with skill. Rockwell International Management stimulates the work of its 120,000 employees, 1 in 6 a scientist or engineer. Their elegant solutions to customer needs make Rockwell a world leader. Rockwell International. Managing high technology for global markets.
Oh. Just like that, this AC copper core spark plug can fire 30 times. That's the firepower today's high-revving car engines need. What about your plugs? If they can't fire for up to 30,000 miles, oh, maybe you're missing out on peak performance. For the AC Delco retailer nearest you, just give me a call at 1-800-AC-DELCO. Wait for trouble, and you've got it.
Era, Bo was complaining that Sims was offside. How'd he get in?
Here he is right here as the white man. They've got three men they have to pick up, so these men block, and he's free, but he is not offside. He's right on the ball. You'll see him come and chase a run action pass from the backside. He's got great speed. Harbaugh turns to throw, but Sims is right there. A big play, and then, of course, Moons misses a field goal.
Ken Sims knocking a ball free inside the five-yard line in the first quarter. Now a great tackle. The Hawkeyes pound ahead with Bayless up the middle, out to the 23-yard line. Andre McIntyre, Dave Folkertsma. And on that tackle. Well, tomorrow, doubleheader day on CBS. There's some of our opening attractions. The Bears going against Minnesota. Dallas against Buddy Ryan's Eagles. The Niners down in Atlanta. St. Louis against Washington. And then the doubleheader game. The Giants against Seattle. And Detroit against Los Angeles. And we will start our coverage tomorrow at 12:30 Eastern time with the NFL Today. This is second and seven for Vlasic and the Hawkeyes. And Bayless comes back out, getting close to a first down, which is the 30-yard line. Andy Moeller in on top of him. Harry, you get the feeling that Hayden wants a drive, but he also wants to work that clock down a little bit. Doesn't want to leave Harbaugh with a whole lot of time here if he can avoid it.
Also wants to avoid any kind of mistake deep in his own territory that would allow another field goal opportunity for Michigan.
It's third and one here for Hayden and the Hawkeyes. And Hudson started off the field and now comes back, and Morrow runs off. So there was confusion on this play, and timeout is called. A costly timeout. There was confusion on the field regarding the substitution pattern. The Hawkeyes will have two timeouts when we return to Ann Arbor in a moment. Michigan Stadium, sellout crowd on hand, and next week, well, it's welcome to the land of the quarterback, John Brody, Jim Plunkett, John Elway, now this young man, John Pay, the Stanford Cardinal quarterback, and he's another good one. You'll get an opportunity to see him in action next week against the Trojans of USC. There are a handful of college quarterbacks who are going to get a long look from the NFL, and Pay certainly is one of them. He can deliver it with the best of them. So USC and Stanford will be the game that most of you will see at 3:30 Eastern time. And the other game, well, should be a good one, real competitive down there in the ACC. The Clemson Tigers against the North Carolina State Wolfpack. Again, we'll start at 3:30 Eastern time. That's the status here. Two unbeatens, and they should come down to the last 5 minutes with the game on the line, and they have right here. Mark Vlasic coming in from the sideline. He brings Bass with him. There was confusion that time. Hudson and Morrow weren't sure who should be on the field for the play. And before they took a 5-yard penalty, they used a timeout. So this is third and short. And this time they run Hudson for that first down behind the left side of that talented offensive line.
See the offensive blocking coming off the line, and this time, instead of being stopped short as they were earlier, Hudson comes through there and makes it without any difficulty.
So it's first and 10. Now in this half, the Hawkeyes on first down have been held to 2.7 yards. Contrast that to the first half when it was 6.8. So the defensive adjustments were made by coordinator Gary Moeller. The back almost moved. Came to a set, and then they gave it to Bass, and he followed the left side of that offensive line out to the 36-yard line, and Dieter Heron, 35, bringing him down there. The clock running inside the 4:15 mark. Era.
That time, Iowa deployed in what would be appeared to be a passing formation, but when Michigan goes out to cover them, then they slip the ball to the fullback. It's either or, I guess. If Michigan doesn't go out there, they're probably going to throw it. He's running a lot of time off that clock. There's under 4 minutes now.
They run the draw play with Hudson. Hudson for the first down. He runs hard out to the 48-yard line before Tony Gant
push him on.
Wraps him up. That's a 12-yard run by Hudson.
Look at how deep this secondary is of Michigan's. They're way back here 15 yards to cover the deep stuff, but they're vulnerable to the run. As you see here, the Hudson cracks the line of scrimmage, and you have an open field tackle here.
Great block by Harmon on number 49, Moeller. He took him off his feet. Hudson has rushed for 53 yards here this afternoon. They split the backs. They run Hudson, and they stop him. It'll be second and long at the 3:22 mark, and there's that nose guard, Billy Harris, getting in there again.
Well, he really pursued that time. There was a little misdirection in there, trying to get the linebackers to go one way, but they didn't fool Harris.
Well, we came in talking about the injuries to the Hawkeye team, but it's a couple of players who came up healthy today who could be the headlines. Hudson and Vlasic trying to pull this one out as we get inside the three-minute mark. 17 all. Vlasic, 4-4 for 64 yards. Hudson has rushed for 54 yards. Bayless breaks free, gets inside the 45-yard line running hard. So the clock running and Iowa getting down closer and closer against Bo Schembechler's defensive unit.
Well, that first guy does not get Bayless down. Looks like he stopped and bounces off of people and bleeds yardage.
A little over a yard to go for the first down. Three substitutes come in, including Craig Clark. So they'll have two tight ends in this tie-dye formation. The pitch, the pass, he fumbles it. Michigan jumps on the ball on the far sideline. They've got a chance at the 157 mark. Andy Moeller, the defensive captain, goes and gets the biggest turnover of the afternoon.
The thought was good here. They really had the play, but he fumbled the ball. He double fakes inside, then comes down on the option, and they had the corner. I think he would have gotten the first down, although it had been close, but he fumbled the football.
Remember that Michigan has another field goal kicker. His name is Gillette, and he nailed a 53-yarder early on. They do not have to get real close for him to have a shot. Here's White, down to the 45 with the clock running. Inside of 150. George Davis runs him down over there. And oh, how the heart aches when you lose a ball at a moment like that. And Gillette starting to loosen up already for Bo Schembechler. We're tied at 17. A year ago in this same situation, but we were in Iowa City, and the Hawkeyes behind Chuck Long went on a winning march for Rob Houtland. Now it is Jim Harbaugh who has an opportunity to return the favor here before his home crowd. Jokic bringing the play in from the sideline, and Kolasar leaves.
And Michigan has all of their timeouts left.
This is a second and four situation. Jokic and McMurtry are the wide men for Harbaugh. He's going to put it up. Over the middle, complete to Morris. First down to the 37-yard line. They stop the clock at the 1:12 mark with the Wolverines coming down the field here. And Schembechler is going to bring Harbaugh over to the sideline.
Here's the replay of it. Just a little dunk pass to Jamie Morris, and he bleeds the first down out of it. Now you've got a timeout here. It leaves him two more with a minute and 12 to go.
We'll be right back. Here was the man of the hour in Iowa City a year ago, Rob Houtland, who kicked the field goal that gave Iowa the victory with no time remaining. Now this afternoon, the Wolverines are trying to win in that fashion. At this point, it would be a 55-yard field goal, so Michigan needs to pick up some more real estate. And Harbaugh straight back with time. Drops it off to White on the screen. He's inside the 30. There's a penalty marker down. A penalty marker down on the field. It was a 21-yard run by White, but there was a flag. And there's the clip. Against the Wolverines.
It was a good call as far as the screen was concerned. And of course, the clip is going to take them back again.
Now, there is Kolasar coming in behind. He slips free. And no, that is not a clip on him. You see the man on the ground right there? That could be Michael Dames, the left guard, number 76, who had already pushed him down. Keep an eye and see if he didn't deliver the clip.
That's the
yes,
one.
He did.
That's it, right.
And
there.
He clipped on Keaton Smiley, number 44, the corner. It was an excellent call. The ball is back at the 41, 102 left. This is first and 14. Harbaugh. Left side, incomplete. Smiley was working on the coverage against Ken Higgins.
It was a good throw by Harbaugh. And Smiley was right there. Let's see whether or not Smiley knocks that ball out of his hands. Here's a look. No, he should have had the ball. That's unusual for Higgins. He's an outstanding receiver. Went right through his hands.
It is second and four. 56 seconds remaining. Michigan and Iowa are tied at 17. They run the delay, and Morris squirts to the 33-yard line. That is short of the first down. But it was a good gain. The clock has stopped with 50 seconds remaining. Aaron.
Got it out of bounds to stop the clock, which is very important. Now they come up with a third down and about 5 or 6 yards. Here it is, just a little draw play. A good call because they're anticipating the pass. Haight almost comes off of his block to come back. There's Smiley, misses the tackle, number 44, and he finally gets out of bounds.
Now Gillette from this point would have to kick a 48-yard field goal. 50 seconds to go on third down. Here's Morris trying to turn it up. He finds daylight. And he was close to a first down when he finally went down.
What a job of running. They had him back there. Was going to force a field goal. I think he's awful close to that first down. Watch this running by Jamie Morris. Looks like they've got him. Burke number five. Then it's overrun. He cuts back to the daylight and gets the first down.
We've got a Hawkeye injured. It is Myron Kepi, the defensive lineman. So we're going to take a break, and we'll be right back for the final 44. Not much changes in a year, Coach.
Isn't that the truth? Here we're down to 44 seconds. They are in field goal range now. It would be a long one, about 44, 45 yards.
First down for Harbaugh, and they run Perriman. He gets inside the 25-yard line. Each yard, remember, reduces the distance that Gillette would be attempting this field goal. Time down to 36 seconds.
Timeout, Michigan.
And Michigan with one timeout remaining.
And they've got a second down situation. You wonder whether or not he would give Harbaugh a safe pass to throw.
Well, I'll tell you, Eric, if he's going to throw a safe pass, the one thing I'm going to tell him is
don't you dare throw it in the direction of a young man by the name of Ken Sims.
You got that all right. Sims has done it the last two games in a row. He denied Michigan State 2 weeks ago, and last week at the Wisconsin game, he picked off another one that was very important to the outcome of the game.
I'll say one thing about Hayden Fry and the Hawkeyes. Boy, they give you some football games, don't they?
They really do.
They're right down into it every time we get them the last 2 minutes. They should have invited you and I out to do the Rose Bowl. Errol, what would you do in this situation if you were down there and the Irish were at this point late in the game, forgetting what Bo may or may not
do? I wouldn't take any chance. I'd punt.
You always did.
That's what I would do, exactly what I would do. I would put the ball up on what I would call a safe pass to tell the quarterback, if it's not there, throw it out of bounds. Then on third down, run it. Then take your last time out. Let the clock run down so that you don't give it back to your opposition, and the kicker's either going to win it or lose it for you.
Okay. It would be a 41-yard field goal.
Make sure you line by the way.
It's Colasar in motion.
Screen.
Dumps it off on the screen to Morris. Morris gets to the 20-yard line. Block running at the 25-second mark.
He's going to have a kick from the hash mark. I thought they'd run a play. Well, they should run a play to the right to get it more in the middle of the field. 12 seconds. 11.
They don't want a penalty here.
That's right.
Right up the middle with White.
Five.
They'll call the timeout.
Going to be Mike Gillette,
who earlier today kicked the longest field goal in Michigan history, the 53-yarder. Jim Harbaugh turns it over to Gillette, who is a remarkable story in his own right. A year ago, he was number one as a kicker on this team, and then there was some disciplinary action handed out the day before the Ohio State game, and Moons replaced him as the short man. Gillette played baseball. He was a catcher on the Michigan baseball team. This spring, he has come back, and he's regained his job. He became the kickoff man and the deep man. Now, you know what the coach is saying, that they got to get in. They put the headset on Ken Sims. So I would say, Era, that we should keep an eye on him. They have sent him through on a blitz down here at the goal line. And from the backside, he got Harbaugh. And with that headset on, obviously one of the assistants upstairs telling him the alley from which to approach Gillette. This will be a 35-yard attempt.
Gillette,
and it comes down to this.
Gillette cannot pause too long because he'll be there.
Time called. Iowa will try to ice the young man down. He goes over to the sidelines. We'll be right back. Mike Gillette with a 34-yard field goal attempt that would keep Michigan unbeaten and headed toward a Rose Bowl and a possible national championship.
Come on, baby. Is this a different kicker? Is that what somebody said? Mark Lossick said this is a different kicker.
Yes, it is. It's Gillette who hit you with the 53-yarder. Gillette has spent a lot of time running back and forth from the sideline. Gillette with a kick that could win it. It's on its way, and he's got it. Michigan beats Iowa.
Out of the field to be on the other side of the ball.
turn. We didn't play well today, but we won.
You and Mike were laughing together right before he kicked it. What did you say to him?
Hey, they don't know this kid. He's a great competitor. He's a baseball player. He was a quarterback. He wasn't going to fluster. They couldn't do that.
Well, one more question. What does this game mean for the Michigan team?
Well, it means we're still up on top. We played poorly. My gosh, we played poorly. But we won the game, and that's what counts.
You got the win. Congratulations, Bo. Let's go to Brent.
What a moment for Mike Gillette. The sophomore from St. Joseph, Michigan, who attended St. Joe's High School, who had lost his job prior to the Ohio State game because of disciplinary reasons, comes in here today and kicks the longest in the school's history, and then at this moment, it's most important, the one that beats Iowa 20-17. His coach over on the sideline. A typical Michigan-Iowa game. Four of the last six games between these two schools have been decided by a field goal. A year ago, it was Hayden Fry. He was laughing and cheering and jumping. Today, he bows his head. Next year, it'll be Hayden Fry's turn. Back after these messages from your local station.
This is CBS.